Nick at Night, the place for TV is Nick at Night, the place for TV hits.
Hey, you.
Huh?
Suit up, strap in, and ask yourself, do you have it?
Have what?
Nickelodeon Guts, now for your Super Nintendo Entertainment System. This is serious, realistic sports action just like the show, only now you're in total control. Compete against the clock or challenge a friend as you take on seven of Guts' toughest events, including the awesome Aggro Crag. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah!
Best out of three? Nickelodeon Guts, only on the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. Also from Nickelodeon, Rocko's Modern Life, the game.
What you got there, kids?
Cooties, Grandpa.
Oh, your dad had cooties when he was a little guy.
Remember the fun of cootie?
I'm ahead.
Now you can pass it on to your kids.
I'm a leg away from winning.
Build a whole cootie to win.
Ta-da!
He's a beauty.
No, he's a cootie.
And don't forget, don't break the ice.
I'm on thin ice.
Grandpa.
Pass on the fun of don't break the ice and cootie. And there's ants in the pants and don't spill the beans, too.
Nick at Night presents classic TV poetry. Sound by Fugue, number 7.
But you're kind of funny talking to a snail.
Is he a living American male?
You don't have to be a whale.
American male?
We have been in jail!
You don't have to be a whale to write Moby Dick.
To get rich quick.
Perhaps Shakespeare must have had to drive him off with a stick.
You're right. There's a really great television on tonight.
Yeah, that happens to me every night.
Nick at Night, every night.
Next up tonight, it's the Mary Tyler Moore Show, followed by Taxi, and then Newhart. Because you're tuned to
Nick at Night.
Episode number 58 features a guest starring role for Bert Convy.
Nickelodeon, by day, bright, rowdy, and easygoing. But every Saturday night, explore a side of Nickelodeon you never knew existed when we ask, are you afraid of the dark? Nick's new show spins ghastly tales of ordinary kids and their not-so-ordinary encounters with a supernatural, daring you to take some one-way rides into nightmare territory. There's only one question. Are you afraid of the dark? Find out every Saturday night at 9:30, 8:30 Central on SNICK.
On the only network for you, Nickelodeon.
Debbie, these shots are fabulous. Beautiful, Debbie.
Better than the last time, Tony?
Absolutely.
It's my job to make sure people look good. A few weeks ago, while doing test shots with Debbie, I noticed something. Dandruff. So I told her about Head & Shoulders. You see, regular shampoos merely rinse flakes away, so they could come back. But look, Head & Shoulders helps stop flakes from even forming. You see the difference? Yeah, picture perfect. Head & Shoulders turns dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
It looks like another routine day in the WJM newsroom for Mary Richards and Ted Baxter. But let's look at this scene again with Nick at Night's classic TV rewind. On repeat viewing, it seems that Ted Baxter's hand is quicker than the eye when he magically transforms a teacup into a personalized coffee mug, making this a very paranormal episode of the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Classic TV rewinds, a second look at shows that are always worth a second look on Nick at Night.
Hi, man.
Hi.
Here's that stuff you wanted to borrow. Oh,
thank you. Sure. Gee, I really feel terrible about always borrowing your good things whenever I am having company.
Oh, don't be silly, kid. This is the only chance my tablecloth gets to have a nice time.
You know, I always wondered, you have so many beautiful serving things and you hardly ever have any company.
Oh, for years now, my mother has been giving me shower gifts on my birthdays. Yeah, I'm the only kid in the world, I'm sure, that got a waffle iron on her 16th birthday. My fancy tablecloth, your good silver.
Which is also my everyday silver.
My everyday silver is plastic.
What?
Who's coming to dinner?
Oh, Jack and Linda Foster.
Jack and Linda?
Mm-hmm.
All this fuss for a couple?
Ah, well, they're very special people.
No, special people seldom come in couples.
Listen, all I know is that Jack and Linda have something really great going. I mean, of all the married couples I know, theirs is the kind of marriage I would like to have for myself.
would like Pat and Dick Nixon's. Why? You know he can't fool around.
But I'm not. Hey, listen, there's plenty of food. Why don't you stay and have dinner with us? I mean, it's about time my friends met each other.
I would really love to, Mia, but I gotta go out and break up with a guy tonight.
Oh, I didn't know you were going with anyone.
Oh, yeah. This would have been our second date.
Well, if you've only dated him once, why don't you break up with him on the phone?
I gotta give him his ring back.
He bought you a ring after one date?
No, he had it with him.
Oh.
It was adjustable. It had a decoder on it.
Hello!
Hello, Mary.
Oh, Linda, don't you look great?
Well, that's what a week skiing in the hospital will do for you.
Baby!
Yeah.
How are you, beautiful?
Oh, I'm fine. I am just fine. Thanks for asking.
Rhoda Morgenstern, I'd like you to meet Linda and Jack Foster.
Oh, hi. I am so glad to finally meet you two.
Yeah, same here. Mary has told us so much about you.
Mary, you were right, kid. They are nice. Listen, I gotta go. Hey, maybe I can get a couple like them for myself. Or we could quadruple.
Oh, yeah.
Come on in.
Mary, fantastic.
Doesn't it drive you crazy? People who can eat anything they want and never get fat, like Jack. And you. I get fat.
When?
I am fat right now.
What are you talking about?
It's true. I got on the scale this morning and I weighed 120 big ones. Diet begins tomorrow.
You're incredible.
Yeah, how much do you weigh?
Almost as much as you do.
Yeah.
Linda, why can't you make coffee like this?
Mrs. Olson, why can't I ever make good coffee? Hey, why don't we finish our coffee in the
good coffee area?
Jack. Remember that crazy Greek brandy you said you liked so much but you could never find?
Oh, yeah, the kind with the tree inside the bottle.
Guess who found some?
Ah, Mayor, I've said it before, but after Linda here, you're the girl I'd marry.
Well, I keep telling you, get rid of her. She's not your type, anyway.
Eddie? Yes, happy little tree.
So, tell me all about Aspen.
Hey, met a great guy for you.
No kidding. What's he do?
Kisses wives.
What?
The rest of the time he's a ski instructor, but mostly he kisses wives.
Jack, you're not going to tell Mary about that, are you? Come on, you tell me your ski instructor stories, I'll tell you mine.
Well, I was three chairs behind them on the lift, and I saw him kiss her.
Well, he took me by surprise. What'd you expect me to do, jump off? I mean, he just grabbed me and kissed me. What was I supposed to do?
What do you think those sharp points on the end of your ski poles are for?
Then you think this kissing ski instructor would be a perfect guy for me, huh?
Well, I don't know, Mayor. I don't know what kind of guys you like. You never said how you liked Arthur.
Arthur who?
Arthur, the guy we fixed you up with?
Last week? Oh, right, Arthur, right. The one who hums a lot.
That's the one. How'd you like
him? Oh, he was, very nice. That's funny. I kind of like him.
Well, listen, I've still got lots of single friends, and we're going to keep trying till we find the right
one. You hang in there, because I'm pulling for you.
Am I too late for dessert?
No, come on in.
No, no, sit down.
How'd it go?
With Leonard, you mean? See, I had a date tonight with this guy I was going to break up with.
So, did you?
Nah, I couldn't.
Why not?
He didn't show.
First 10. We're on the air in 10 minutes.
Well, he went to get a haircut over 2 hours ago. I don't know what's taking him so long.
Well, maybe he's trying to find a barber who gives lollipops. Ratings came in.
Oh, how are they this month?
The question should be, where are they this month? Listen, if Ted doesn't show up, I think we'll try a little experiment. Go on the air without him and see if dead air does better than he does. Ted, it's terrific. Would you buy a used chariot from this man?
And my hairstyle. How do you like it, Mayor?
Well, Ted, it's just...
I think so, too. Look at this. Notice how it all falls naturally back into place?
Yeah, everything but your eyes. Ted, I cannot believe that you would spend money to have your hair styled.
When you're a big celeb, you can work these things out, you know?
I told him I'd plug his barbershop on the news.
Oh, well, Ted, I'm sorry, but I can't let you do that.
Oh, sure you can. Of course, I didn't tell him he'd have to be robbed, burned down, or picketed before I could do it. Well, what do you think of your new anchorman?
Thank goodness you're here. You can't believe the jerk we've had up to now.
It's not funny, Lou.
On the air in four minutes.
Oh, Mary, look, if your car's still in the garage, I'll give you a lift home after the show.
Oh, well, thanks anyway, Murray, but I have a dinner date.
Huh? New boyfriend?
No, an old couple. Fosters are picking me up.
Ted,
I'll be there in plenty of time.
Have I ever missed a show?
No.
Excuse me, is this where I'll find Mary Richards?
Yeah!
Hello, Mary.
Give me just a second.
All right.
Ted, good friends sometimes hug each other. Of course, you'd have no way of knowing that.
You must be Jack Forster. I'm Murray Slaughter. Hi, nice to meet you.
Lou Grant.
Lou?
Hi.
That's right, it's me.
What are you doing here so early? You weren't supposed to pick me up until 7.
Oh, no. Oh, well, I it's been one of those days, Mary.
But see, the thing is, I don't know if I can get away early.
Go ahead. I'll cover for
you. Oh, thank you, Mr. Grant. Where's Linda? Downstairs?
No.
Oh, is she going to meet us at the restaurant?
No.
She's not sick or anything, is she?
No. She's fine, just fine. It's just that we're separated.
I can't believe that you and Linda aren't going to be able to work this thing out.
I know.
Hiya. Rhoda, what are you doing here?
Mary, you should never go out and leave your bathtub running.
Oh, no, I did?
No, I did. But it dripped through a little. But I mopped it all up, so don't worry.
Gee, if I knew Mary was having company, I would have used my good sponge mop. So, Jack, I see you found the right guy for Mary at last.
Oh, Rhoda. No, you're not so dumb, kid. You pick a great couple for friends, so you're right there when the husband's available.
No, smart. Rhoda, listen.
So where is Linda, you two?
I'm not sure.
Oh. Oh, why didn't you hit me?
No.
Oh, I am so sorry. Really, I could die. I could just drop dead on this very spot. I really...
She didn't know.
I know.
Hey, I didn't know.
Would you like some coffee? It'll just take a minute, then we can talk some more.
No, Mary, thanks. I've got an early tennis game tomorrow.
Oh?
With my lawyer.
Oh, Jack. No, has it gone that far that you have to play tennis with your lawyer?
I guess it has.
Well, I just feel terrible. I wish there was something I could say or do. You, Linda.
Oh, it's enough that you care, Mary.
Oh, I do.
You know, I'm glad we had dinner together like this tonight.
Hey, me too. And I'm sure you guys are going to be able to work it out. You're both too good to let this happen.
Thanks, Mary. You're a good friend.
Me too.
Well... boy, you really know you're separated when you're afraid to hug your friend. Now, come on, Mary.
Right.
That's silly.
Fresh-baked bread, piled with extra lean, juicy ham. Oven-roasted turkey breast, topped with a classic taste of...
Pardon me, would you have any Grey Poupon?
But of course.
Introducing Subway's new turkey and ham Dijon. Turkey, ham, and the great taste of Grey Poupon mustard. Now for a limited time on your choice of rolls at Subway, the place where fresh is the taste.
One of the ways Ryder makes your move easier is by renting trucks with automatic transmission. Because moving doesn't have to be an uphill battle. Ryder, we're there when you need us.
The opening sequence of the Mary Tyler Moore Show took a nothing day and made it part of our television heritage. The words and images that were chosen said it all. It was 1970 and the women's movement put Mary Richards at the wheel. An independent woman dealing with economics, work, men. Tossing away her hat, Mary put the past behind her, celebrating her new freedom. The opening changed through the seasons, but that final moment always remained. Nick at Night is preserving our television heritage.
You know what really bothers me? They're seeing their lawyers. Now I'm afraid they won't get back together.
Well, it all depends on how good the lawyer is. If he's really good, they don't have a chance.
You know, that's true, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Oh, my cousin. Oh, he was the greatest divorce lawyer. He used to chase cars with just married on the back.
Terrific, Rhoda. I am really upset and you're making jokes.
Mary, I'm only doing this, dear girl, because you have the tendency of taking these things like they're the end of the world. And they're not. I'm not going to say anymore. The next thing I was going to say would really shock you.
Oh, gee, Rhoda, I kind of doubt that.
All right, here it goes. Your friend, Jack?
Yes.
Formerly of Jack and Linda?
Mm-hmm.
Is going to call you up and ask you for a date.
No!
Morgan Stern predicts.
Well, I wouldn't go out with him.
No, I know, not on a date you wouldn't, but if he asked you out to discuss his marriage, would you do that?
Well, of course I would.
That will be your first date.
Well, I've already done that.
Aha! I'm one for one.
Hello? Oh, hi, Jack. Well, I'm fine, thank you. How are you? Oh, listen, I'm glad we had that talk, too. You're welcome. Oh, Jack, that's a great idea. Linda will love it. How could anyone say no to dinner and roses? Me? Well, okay, sure. 8 o'clock will be just fine. Bye. Well, the reason that I said yes to going out with him is because he wants to see me as a friend.
I understand that. Now, would you like to hear Morgan Stern's next prediction?
No!
But Leon, I did mention your barbershop last night on the show. Right before the revolution in South America. You probably just missed it. You saw the whole show, huh? Well, I thought I did. Look, I'll do it tonight. But Leon, I said I'd plug your shop, I'll plug your shop. Just don't worry about it, Leon. All right. What are you working on, Mer?
A story about a meeting with all the Arab chiefs of state.
Any chance of working the name Leon Silverman into that?
Hi, Mer. Good friends like us sometimes do that.
No, they don't, Ted. Not ever again.
Mary, you see this tie I'm wearing?
Yes, sir.
Janie gave it to me, and I haven't had the nerve to wear it. But I'm having lunch with her today, and I think I ought to. Well, I don't know if I can go through it. What do you think?
Well, Mr. Grant, I like it.
Yeah?
Look, it's bright, it's wide, bright in style.
I guess everybody likes it. If only somebody would say they didn't like it.
I don't like it, Lou. I think it's really hideous.
My daughter bought me this tie.
Oh. Well, let me look at it again, Lou. Maybe under another light, Lou.
Hey, Marie, can I ask you something?
Sure, anything.
Would you say you and Marie have a good marriage?
Is that your question, or did my wife leave a message while I was out?
My question.
No, well, I guess it's a good marriage. But on the other hand, I also think this is a good job. Why?
Oh, I know. It's good to know there are some good marriages left.
Yeah. I could only think of one thing that could make us get divorced.
What?
If she invited Ted for dinner.
Only everybody takes divorce so lightly.
Well, it's not so rare, Mary. It happens a lot.
Hey, Ted, remember that show we did last week on the divorce? Did you remember the statistics?
What was that again, Mur?
I almost asked Ted a question.
Go ahead, Murray, ask.
It's all right, Ted, it's all right.
Ask me, please.
Well, do you remember that night we did the show on divorce?
Yes.
Mary, why all this sudden interest in divorce? Are you planning on getting married?
No, but my friends, the Fosters, are splitting up, and, well, last night I was out with Jack.
Oh, you were out with Jack?
No, Murray, I wasn't out with Jack. I was out with Jack.
Hi there.
Linda! I know it's lunchtime, but I took a chance you might be here.
Linda, hi.
Gee, I'm glad you did. And, well, listen, now that you mention it, how about lunch?
Gee, I can't. I should be at work now.
Uh-huh. Well, you want to have lunch or...
I can't.
Right, you said that.
But, Mary, there is something I wanted to tell you.
Oh, excuse me. I'll check the wire and see if anything broke on the Leon Silverman story.
It's about Jack and me.
Oh, Linda, I know. You're separated.
It was the shortest separation on record.
Oh, Linda, that's great. I knew it would work out.
Well, it did. We're getting divorced.
Wait, is that for sure?
Yep. Mary, I was tired of being a housewife. I have my own identity. I want to fulfill myself in other ways.
Well, what are you going to do?
First, I'm going to start dating again. Hey, have you met anyone interesting lately?
Well, yeah, but you wouldn't like him.
Oh. Well, if I meet somebody, maybe we can get together.
Sure, sure.
And let's keep in touch, and I'll talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
You know, Mary, I love sitting next to you. The guy who used to sit at that desk only talked about crabgrass.
We're so uptight about Jack.
Okay, I know you and probably everybody else thinks I'm really stupid. It's been 5 weeks. Jack's not upset. Linda's not upset. But me, I am upset.
Well, like they always say, in a divorce, it's the little one who gets hurt most.
I know, you're right. It's silly, isn't it?
Yes.
No, it's not. Rhoda, I can't go out with him again. Tonight is the last time. I just don't feel right about seeing him on a dating basis.
Mary, we've been friends a long time, right? So I'd like to give you a little bit of advice. You're a dummy.
You think it's perfectly all right for me to go out with Jack?
Man, not only do I think it's all right, the whole world thinks it's all right. Lawrence Welk thinks it's all right. They are getting a divorce. It's in the courts, Mary. If you don't go out with him, you're breaking the law.
Rhoda, it's so hard to have a discussion with you. You never have an opinion.
Jack. Hi, Mary.
Hello, Jack.
Hi, Rhoda.
Hiya.
Sorry I'm early.
That's all right.
Well, it's 8 o'clock. I better get upstairs and make my bed.
Rhoda! You mean a girl like you staying home tonight?
Incredible, isn't it?
Hey, Rhoda, listen. Why didn't you come with us? Huh? It would be all right, wouldn't it, Jack?
Well, sure.
No, I could not.
Oh, come on. Look, we're just going to dinner.
Come on, Rhoda. We're not going anyplace expensive or anything.
I don't know.
Well, how about if we go someplace expensive?
Then I'll go. Boy, what a fancy restaurant. I mean, everything that came out was flaming, including the busboy.
How kind you liked it, Rhoda.
Oh, yeah, I did. But, you know, it was not right that you paid for it.
No. My pleasure.
You didn't invite me. Mia did. Right, Mary?
Yeah.
See? She can pay for me.
Come on, sit down. How about coffee?
Fine.
I'll help you.
What was that all about?
I guess she figured we wanted to be alone.
Yes. I knew I'd like that girl. Mary, I think it's time for you and me to be honest with each other.
Oh, gosh, Jack, I don't think it's time for that.
Now, listen.
No.
Please, even when Linda and I were married...
Absolutely not.
Mary.
Okay.
Even then. Didn't you ever wonder what would have happened if you'd met me before?
Oh, no, no. You know, maybe somebody like you, you know, sort of exactly like you, but not you.
I'm like me.
Jack, I just don't feel right about it. You, Linda, what if you two got back together again? I mean, boy, there would be a real mess. I
know what you mean, but we won't. Linda is going out. She's dating that guy, Arthur.
The Hummer?
Right. So what do you want to do?
You know, I just figured out what's bothering me. It's so simple. All I have to do is make sure that Linda doesn't mind.
Oh, but she won't mind.
Okay, I'm going to go see her tomorrow. And tomorrow night, if you're free, I will fix you the most fantastic dinner.
Terrific. Mary, as long as you're going to be talking to her, I'd like you to ask her something for me.
Sure, what?
Ask her what cleaner she took my gray suit to.
Hi, Mary.
Hello, Linda.
Come on in.
Well, everything looks the same. I thought it would have changed a little, but it hasn't. It's exactly the same, almost.
Oh, Mary, you remember Arthur Price?
Sure, yes.
Of course, you dated him.
Right. He used to be a friend of,
Jack's.
And Linda's.
Well, he still is. Aren't you, Arthur?
Guess you might say that.
Oh, I don't know how you ever let him get away.
Oh, well, you know.
Well, I've got to pick up those tickets, Lynn. I'll be back in an hour.
Okay.
Nice to see you again, Mary.
Thank you.
Oh, Mary, I've never been happier in my life.
Oh, Linda, you don't know how happy I am to hear that.
I mean really happy. I mean so happy I wake up humming. How are things going with you? Now, how's that new guy you mentioned?
Well, it's funny you should ask that, because, well, I guess that's why I'm here. Look, I know you won't mind, but, well, you know me, dumb old Mary, super cautious, has to get permission. I just wanted to make sure that it's okay with you if I see Jack. So it's okay with you, isn't it?
No.
What?
I don't want you to date him.
But you just said...
I know what I just said. Oh, and as far as I'm concerned, Jack can date anyone he wants. A cocktail waitress, a secretary, a bunny. But not you.
Well, why not me?
Because I say so.
Oh, well, I see. What about after the divorce?
No.
Well, what about if you and Arthur got married?
No.
Well, look it, after you and Arthur are married, then you can't tell me no anymore. And, where's Jack's gray suit?
So, Dave, how was San Francisco?
It was great. Did you drive across the Golden Gate Bridge?
No.
Did you see Alcatraz?
Is that there?
Well, what did you do?
I found this sourdough roll.
Introducing Wendy's Sourdough Bacon Cheeseburger. It's a San Francisco-style roll stuffed with a quarter pound of fresh beef, Monterey Jack, bacon, and Dijon sauce.
Reminds me of when I was in San Francisco. I met this sailor and...
Hey, look at the time.
Gotta go.
Yes, well, we only went to the library.
You can find it in San Francisco and at any Wendy's.
Wherever you are this summer, could be a very cool place. With Miller's 10 grand a day giveaway, we've got a lot to unload. That's $10,000 a day, every day. Look for numbers inside specially marked cases of Miller beer. Match and win daily in USA Today and Sports Illustrated. A lot of cash, a lot of winners. Can your beer do this?
When TV Guide chose the all-time best TV, we weren't surprised. When Entertainment Weekly chose the best TV, we weren't surprised. When you're looking for the all-time best TV, it's no surprise you choose Nick at Night, the home of classic TV.
the most beautiful night of my life. I won't be able to believe it was real enough to get tell you about it.
Well, sit down and tell me about it. Well, I thought you went out with Leonard to break up with him.
Yeah, I did. Oh, we had the most gorgeous dinner. Candlelight, soft music, dancing. It was just terrific, really.
Well, then you didn't break up with him.
No, I did. And it was beautiful. I mean, all the chemistry was there, you know what I mean? We weren't kidding each other or ourselves. We knew we'd never see each other again. Oh.
Well, you certainly look happy.
Oh, well, sure. It's that special glow a girl gets when she's not in love.
Hello? Oh, hi. Well, no, I just don't think we should go out. Look, you know why. Linda would be very upset. No, really, I just wish you wouldn't call again. Thank you. Goodbye, Arthur.
Just one taste of Honey Bunches of Oats cereal and you'll love it instantly.
Honey Bunches of Oats? You're not going to convince me. I'm convinced, like I was saying, this is special.
Starting with those toasty flakes of corn and wheat.
What makes you think this is the one? This is the one. This is great.
Combined with those honey-kissed oat clusters in every mouth-watering bite.
If you really want me to try it, okay, I'll try it, but no promises, okay?
Whoa.
Post Honey Bunches of Oats. One taste is all it takes.
Whoa.
Tough day, huh, kiddo?
We're doing fractions in math. And Gracie Gibson kissed me on the playground in front of everybody.
Yuck. Sounds like you need a bedtime story.
Mom.
Car chases?
Cool.
When your day needs a little turnaround, Blockbuster has 9,000 ways to make it a Blockbuster night.
How about another story?
Yeah, I got one. With boys kissing girls.
He needed a job. They needed a coach. Both had a lot to learn. Grab a front row seat as Nick at Night brings back a show that definitely deserves a second look. Return to the days when sneakers were affordable, shorts were short, and basketball was still a metaphor for life.
You remember.
Ken Howard is the White Shadow.
Oh.
The White Shadow.
Oh.
Saturdays at 10, 9 Central, only on Nick at Night.
There's only one place for better TV today. It's pre-post modern, wild and free. Watch Nick at Night for good TV.
Dick York, Dick Sargent. There's no love lost between these two.
I'll get rid of him so fast it'll make his head spin.
That's crazy.
Tune in when they settle the score once and for all as Nick at Night presents Dueling Darrins, a week-long marathon that brings the color episodes of Bewitched to Nick at Night and gives you the chance to call in toll-free and vote for your favorite Darrin. Don't miss it. All next week starting at 8:30, 7:30 Central, only on Nick at Night.
How'd you like a bust in the bazoo?
Have you flipped? What's gotten into you?
Once upon a time, there was a typical American girl who happened to bump into a typical red-blooded American boy. And she bumped into him and bumped into him. So they decided they'd better sit down and talk this over before they had an accident. They became good friends. They found they had a lot of interests in common. Radio. Television. Trains. And when the boy found the girl attractive, desirable, irresistible, he did what any red-blooded American boy would do. He asked her to marry him. They had a typical wedding, went on a typical honeymoon, in a typical bridal suite. Except, it so happens that this girl is a witch.
It has the perfect balance of nutrients he needs. It makes your dog a mighty dog.
At your local True Value, finding someone to help you isn't a problem. Something that just can't be said of those enormous hardware warehouses.
Mm-hmm. Find them, boys!
This month at True Value, a twin pack of Red Devil Lifetime Caulk is just $1.99, and our True Test True Seal waterproofing is just $4.98 a gallon. True Value. Help is just around the corner.
So you think your neighbor's a witch? Try using Nick at Night's three-step witch test. 1. Look for peculiar facial features. 2. Watch for unusual behavior. 3. Listen for subtle verbal slips.
I am a witch.
But avoid direct confrontation. A witch will never admit she's one.
I'm a witch. I am a witch. I really am a witch.
The best way to spot a real witch is to watch Bewitched. Weeknights at 8:30, 7:30 Central on Nick at Night.
Every young girl needs love and romance. There's one thing she doesn't need.
Mother, what are you doing here?
What am I doing here? What are you doing here?
I'm married.
I know. Let you out of my sight for one moment. Well, hold on to me and we'll be home before you can say...
I don't want to go.
I was afraid of that. He has you under a spell, eh? These male witches are the worst kind.
He's not a witch.
What?
He happens to be, if you'll excuse the expression, a normal mortal human being.
Oh, well, then that's easy. I'll just have him trip over a rug and break a knob.
Mother, you'll leave him alone. He's a dear, sweet, wonderful, perfectly marvelous man.
Oh, my poor baby. He sounds simply horrible. Don't worry, Samantha. I'll get you out of here.
I'm not going.
Really? How would you like to spend your wedding night with a bullfrog?
Don't you understand? I'm happy with him.
Don't talk to your mother like that. I'll tell you when you're happy.
Uh-oh. He's coming in.
I'll take care of that.
Easy now.
Ooh, I'm not going to have it in.
Must be the champagne. May I have my key, please?
Mother, you've got to get out of here. Even witchcraft can't keep him out there all night. It's our honeymoon.
I don't know where you get it. Must be from your father. Certainly not from my side of the family.
Mother, he's coming in and you're going out.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are. Nicholas and follow Sir Nicholas. John!
You are kidding.
I've never been more serious in my life. One Leoria Corianne, Phyllison Follison, Nicholas John, Queevy Quavy, English Navy, Stigrum Staglum Buck. B-U-C-K spells Buck, and out goes you! Are you naughty, naughty little witch? Please? No! You're still very young and inexperienced. You don't know what prejudice you'll run into. They all think that witches work only one day a year on Halloween. We all wear those big ugly hats and fly around on brooms. What if he finds out you're a witch? I'm going to tell him. You're going to tell him?
I don't think married people should have secrets from one another.
When are you going to tell him?
As soon as you leave.
That should solve everything. You'll be home before you know it. Father? Good.
The strangest things have been happening. I took one glass of champagne and suddenly I found myself...
Sweetheart, let's sit down and talk.
What? What?
I'm a witch.
That's wonderful. We'll talk about it tomorrow.
Now, I am a witch. A real house-haunting, broom-riding, cauldron-stirring witch.
It must be the champagne. It's been a hectic day for both of us. This getting married is not as easy as it looks.
Would I say I was a witch if I'm not?
I don't know. I have an aunt who thinks she's a lighthouse. And whenever it rains, she insists on climbing on the garage roof to warn the sailors.
You know, she is the lighthouse.
Huh?
Well, maybe you're the one that's looking straight at the lighthouse and thinks you're seeing an old lady on a garage roof.
Okay. My aunt is a lighthouse, and you're a witch.
You don't believe me.
Okay, if you're a witch, where's your black hat and broom, and how come you're out when it isn't even Halloween?
Mother was right. You're prejudiced.
You told me your mother was in India.
She is. But she dropped in on me this evening.
Here?
Yes.
Is she here now?
No.
Good. Because I don't care for even an invisible mother-in-law along on my honeymoon.
I guess I'll just have to prove to you that I'm a witch.
That's a good idea. Prove it.
I wasn't going to do any more witchcraft for your sake.
I'm from Missouri. You know what that means?
What?
Show me.
I'm not very experienced at it.
Well, you're young yet.
I can only do little things.
A little thing will be just fine. Just any old little thing. I have yet to see a table lighter that works. Just once, I would like to see... Sweetheart, we all imagine things. I myself... I may not believe this, but... Sweetheart, some air.
I wish I had a drink. That old fashioned. And a straw?
You're a witch?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. Darling, are you all right?
No. No, I'm not all right.
Darrin, I suppose I shouldn't have married you, but I love you so much.
I love you too, but I hadn't figured on this.
I'll make you a good wife, I promise.
This is not something like somebody who just thinks they're a lighthouse.
Darrin, I love you so much.
You've got to figure this out. Later.
At GEO, we've thought a lot about safety. That's why GEO Prism comes with standard dual airbags and available anti-lock brakes. In addition, it's equipped with a rugged steel safety cage. You see, we not only want to make accidents easier to avoid, we also want to make them easier to walk away from.
Call 1-800-GET-TO-KNOW and get to know GEO Prism with over 100 standard safety features.
Want to spice up your summer? Win a week at the WMMR Taco Bell Beach House and a chance to win a trip to Cancun, Mexico. Sponsored by Taco Bell. Now open late. To register, just stop by any participating Taco Bell restaurant or send a postcard with your name, address, and daytime phone number to WMMR Taco Bell Beach House, P.O. Box 1767, Philadelphia, PA 19106. From the station that reaches the beaches, 93.3 WMMR.
Nick at Night knows you wouldn't skim through Moby Dick. You wouldn't fast forward through It's a Wonderful Life. When it comes to classics, you savor the magic moment by moment. That's why Nick at Night presents for the first time in 10 years the first 75 classic episodes of Bewitched in their original running order. In the weeks to come, you'll see Darren's first clash with Andorra, Andorra's first brush with the Stevens, and Darren's first taste of witchcraft. It's the only way to watch a classic. Bewitched in order every night on Nick at Night.
And if you can't talk to your best friend, who can you talk to? You know, I know all about marriage. That's why I'm a bachelor.
My problem, Dave.
The sea of matrimony is beset with hidden shoals and reefs.
Just found out Samantha's a witch.
And it takes tolerance and understanding to find the channel of true love.
I didn't believe it until she started moving things around.
Marriage is a partnership where two people side by side face life's obstacles together.
I can't tell my family.
If two people love each other, really love each other, they can move.
I'm having trouble getting my aunt down off the garage roof when it's raining.
Just that is the foundation upon which every lasting marriage is built. Adjust.
Of course, it might have certain advantages, like if you weren't a drink in a dry state.
Well, I gotta go. Listen, if you ever need any help or advice again, just feel free to call on me.
Doc, we've been friends for a long time. I don't know if you can help me or not, but I just had to bring this problem to you.
Darrin, that's what I'm here for. Just tell me what's bothering you.
I'm married to a witch. A real, live, house-haunting, broom-riding, cauldron-stirring, card-carrying witch.
If you came to me for advice, I'll give you some. Now that you've had your honeymoon, why don't you take a vacation?
Al, my wife is a witch.
Cheer up. You should see my wife.
And I've gone over it and over it in my mind. And I've come to a decision. I love you and I can't give you up.
Oh, darling. I would be the best wife a man ever had.
I know you would. We're going to have a nice, normal, happy life together and no more...
No, I promise.
It's not going to be easy. It's tough enough being married to an advertising man if you're normal, but
I mean, you're going to have to learn to be a suburban housewife.
I'll learn. You'll see. I'll learn.
Now, you'll have to learn to cook and keep house.
Mm-hmm.
And go to my mother's house for dinner every Friday night.
Darling, it sounds wonderful. And soon we'll be a normal, happy couple with no problems, just like everybody else. And then my mother can come and visit for a while and... Oh, well, maybe we better work up to that gradually. Oh, I'll try. I promise I'll try.
Whew, I'm glad that's settled. Let's drink to it.
An old-fashioned?
With a cherry on top.
I'll make it myself.
All by yourself. We'll work it out somehow. So my wife's a witch. Every married man has to make some adjustment.
Miss Summers, I'm afraid Mr. Stevens is tied up.
Oh, now, don't give it a thought, Helen. I know he'll be glad to see me. I'll just dash in for a moment. Darrin.
Sheila.
Darling, I just got back from Nassau yesterday, and I've been trying to reach you. I left a message with your secretary, and when I didn't hear from you, I decided to invade your office. Why didn't you call me?
You see, I just got back. I'm married.
Oh, I know, dearest. Congratulations.
Now, I know you've got every reason. You don't care?
Oh, sweetheart, care? Of course I care. After all, if I hadn't left for Nassau when I did, it might have been me. But no hard feelings, you sneak. Oh, Darrin, I couldn't be happier for you, and I'm sure she's an angel. I just stopped by to ask the two of you to drop over tonight if you hadn't any other plans. A few of the gang are coming over for potluck, and, well, I realize it's rather short notice. Nothing fancy, very relaxed, sitting on the floor kind of thing.
Well, that's very nice of you, Sheila, but I don't know. It may be too soon to spring a whole new set of people on her. She's not used to
so
some...
Too soon? Oh, don't be silly. Darrin, we're your friends. We're dying to meet her. Unless, of course, you'd feel uncomfortable.
Me? Well, of course not.
Fine, then it's all set. 7:30 tonight. I've got a dash. See you later.
Some fancy-looking place. Darrin, are you sure I'm dressed all right?
Darling, of course you are. Sheila said it was potluck. Very relaxed. Sitting on the floor kind of stuff.
Oh. Darrin, darling. Is this your little bride? How do you do? Oh, why, Darrin, she's sweet. Maybe I should have dressed... Oh, not at all, dear. You look sweet. John, would you take Mrs. Stevens' sweater? I can tell you're the type who always dresses so sensibly. You know, the capable type. Oh, Darrin, I bet she's good at typing, cooking, taking care of the household accounts, and playing golf. You know, all those things poor little me can't do at all. Pity. Won't you come in and meet my friends? Folks, I'd like you to meet Darren's little bride. It must be Samantha down
here. Oh, yes, I think
it's our younger. Are you all right? Oh, yes, fine, thank you.
Now, don't worry about Samantha, Darrin. We're all going to help her.
Everybody? I said that since Samantha is a stranger here, that we're all going to help her and make her feel at home. Now, first, dear, we've got to get you a good dressmaker. Oh, but I don't need help.
And then we'll introduce you to Pierre. He does wonders with hard-to-manage hair. Have you met somewhere before?
No, I don't think...
Newport?
No.
The Riviera?
No.
Speaking of traveling, remember, Darrin, that time we met in Paris and you said, well, I sent you a telegram.
Darrin, only last night at dinner, Harry was telling me that you were the brightest young prospect in the agency business. Real Madison Avenue know-how.
Sheila always looks so beautiful. Never a hair out of place. A wonderful girl. Nothing she can't do. You know, she owns her own plane.
Oh?
Do you fly?
Oh, yes. Do you know Dr. Hafter, dear? Samantha? Mm-hmm. Beg your pardon? Dr. Hafter, do you know him? No. The plastic surgeon. Does beautiful nose work.
No, I don't know him.
Oh, funny, I could have sworn you...
I won't do it.
Oh, Darrin, do you remember that delightful time we had with the Contessa at Maxine's?
I won't.
Well, anyway, last I heard, they were involved in the most delicious scandal.
Maybe I will.
Oh, and the tennis matches start in East Hampton this Saturday. I thought we could get the same group we had last year. My house is open, and you know we could be weekend of it. Wouldn't that be divine?
We'd so like to have you and Samantha over for dinner next week. If Tuesday's good, Harry's invited Mr. Donahue.
Samantha and I would be glad to come to dinner.
Well, thank you, Mrs. Rutherford. Mr. Donahue...
Remember how cozy it was sitting by the fire, Darrin? How the others... just rain without noticing I'll meet you. It's beyond me.
Wait, you see, the sports guy I had sent over from Europe. It's simply gorgeous.
Reminds me of the one we looked at in California. Oh, by the way, Gregor is in town, so don't plan to be home early for dinner Wednesday night. He's having in a few close friends to show his new paintings, and you must come. Show me what to buy. I'll pick you up at the office at 6.
Her bracelet.
Hey, Sheila!
Let me help you.
Down, I must get the recipe. It's good. It really is.
How can we McSatisfy you?
Well, I really love McDonald's cheeseburgers.
Well, how about a double cheeseburger?
Ooh, can we add some greens and some reds?
Fresh lettuce and tomatoes? You got it. It's called the Daily Double.
Must be double the price.
Nope, just 99 cents.
Are you kidding?
Just 99 cents.
You know, I really love fries, too.
Okay, and a Coke for just $2.99.
Now that's a work of art.
The 99-cent Daily Double. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Blindfold, monsieur?
No.
Cigarette?
No.
What do you want on your tombstone?
Pepperoni and cheese. Tombstone pizza, Pierre!
What do you want on your tombstone? Real meat, real cheese. Much better tasting than pizzas made with imitation cheese. So what do you want on your tombstone?
Napkin?
No.
TV Land's greatest running gag.
I imagine she's very lonesome for Donald.
Daniel.
Darwin.
David.
Another reason to watch Nick at Night brand reruns every night.
Sam, I'm not saying you were entirely wrong. Sheila had it coming, but you went a little far.
For a while there, it was kind of hard to tell which was which.
Sam.
This is a play on words.
I'm only trying to say that you broke your promise. You gave me your word, no more,
stuff. It's a little harder to break the habit than I thought.
Well, you can do it. I've got a lot of faith in you.
Oh, thank you, darling.
It's bedtime.
Mm-hmm. I've just got to get this kitchen cleaned up.
Tomorrow.
That's what you said last night.
Yeah. Don't take too long.
Taper
off. Starts behind the eyes, goes behind the head.
I guess they're stress headaches. I get them right here.
My head is just getting tighter.
You're clenching your teeth.
My daughter does help contribute to my headache.
For fast relief of tough headache pain, now there's extra strength Tylenol gel tabs. All the power of extra strength Tylenol combined with innovative Gelco technology. Nothing works faster.
It goes away really, really quick.
I feel clear-headed again.
Work fast for me.
Tylenol gel tabs, the newest form of powerful pain relief.
Works.
Smart TV viewers compare. In a recent poll, Endora was judged to be twice as feisty as Diane Sawyer. Get more of what you're watching for with Bewitched on Nick at Night.
Time-tested TV pleasure classics in historic mono for the connoisseur or neophyte, only on Nick at Night.
This Saturday night, get back on the bus with me, David Cassidy, and watch my four favorite Partridge Family episodes here on Nick at Night.
Don't miss Very, Very David Cassidy, Saturday at 10, 9 Central.
Singing,
Music we pay. Daddy got Reuben to sell our song, and it really came together when Mom sang along.
Come on now and meet everybody and hear us singing. There's nothing better than being together when we're singing. When we're singing. When we're singing.
Well, I double-checked everything. The bus is loaded and ready to go. Oh, except for the costumes.
Good. I want to get an early start tomorrow, so I want everyone to make sure your costumes are pressed tonight, okay?
Chris went through the seat of his pants again.
Why are you the only one that does that?
It's because I'm the drummer.
I didn't know he played the drums with that part of him.
He doesn't. It only sounds like it.
I bounce up and down a lot.
I have to sew it up.
Dad.
Hi, Grandma.
What are you doing here? Why didn't you phone?
Came on an impulse. Gotten my new toy here and took off. Didn't even tell Amanda where we were headed.
You think I would have climbed into this sardine can if you had?
Grandma, are you feeling all right? Your face looks funny.
Well, your face would look funny if you drove 400 miles nonstop with a maniac at the wheel.
Nonstop?
That fool thinks he's Barney Oldfield.
Who?
Don't ask me. Before my time.
Mom, come on out of there. You'll feel a lot better after you have something to eat.
I'm not sure that I can, dear.
Boys, help Grandma out of the car.
What happened to your DeSoto, Grandpa?
Put her out to pasture. Decided I wanted something more fitting my personality.
In that case, you should have bought a scooter.
Why scooter, Grandma?
Your grandfather had a birthday last week, honey. He became a 5-year-old.
Looks like she's wearing fakes. But it's not. It's Forcey's mascara.
Oh, my shirt's so sexy, it hurts.
The lash is so big, your everyone lash looks like three.
My hair, what you think
about that? Lash is so big, you'll swear it's fake. But it's Forcey's mascara from Ultima 2.
Sexy Toad is yours for just $12.50 with any Ultima 2 purchase at JCPenney.
I had a young couple from Sweden come into my store that was interested in buying a neon sign.
And mailboxes, etc. We can pretty much pack and ship anything.
The first question they asked me is, how do I get it home?
It was a very fragile item.
I made an instant decision to call Mailboxes, etc. my buddy Norm.
The item arrived there with no problem whatsoever.
Norm's Norm. And he's just a cool guy.
Give me a break.
Depend on Mailboxes, etc. It's not what we do, it's how we do it.
Back on the bus with Nick at Night when the Partridge Family grooves with guest stars in 4 fab episodes. Does this Academy Award-winning actress look familiar? Recognize this creepy, kooky guy? Is there a meathead on that motorcycle? Who's Danny's new buddy? Classic episodes, classic faces, classic TV. So get back on the bus with the Partridge Family tomorrow at 8, 7 Central on Nick at Night.
I'd be lousy,
well,
didn't
you? That's a wild sound. Play some more.
Fred, why don't you play Bye Bye Blackbird?
Oh, these kids don't want to hear that old chestnut. We got to keep up with the times.
Who do you think you are, Elvis Preston?
What do you want to play, Granddad?
Oh, how about the song you were playing? You all start and I'll jump in.
Are you sure you know that one?
I'll fake it.
Okay, let's
all
do
right.
it.
Get out. I'll do my thing. Is that what you call it?
Okay, there are the lyrics.
Uh-huh.
It's nip time, you tell me. Am I losing my touch? The hurt you put on me, girl, is more than enough. You were so good to me, girl, needed you to go on. We had ourselves a good thing, is it over and done? I need some time to think, get myself together again. Time to think, I gotta get on my feet again. The woman I used to love ain't the woman I see today. The woman I see today ain't the woman who used to say, baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love, 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 I love you. And baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love, 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 I love you. And baby, I love you. Oh, baby, I love you. Oh, baby, I love, 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 I love you. And baby, I love you. Oh, baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love, 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 I love you. Oh, baby, I love you.
Oh, Dad! Hey, you know he sings good.
You really mean it?
Of course he does. That was really heavy, Granddad.
Heavy? Is that good?
The best.
My song never sounded better. That mandolin really adds something.
Hey, maybe Granddad should join the act.
Oh, let's not get carried away.
Why not? He's a part of the family.
Sure, how about it, Granddad? Wanna come on the road with us? See your name up in lights?
Yeah. That might be heavy.
I really don't know what to do with him, Shirley. Honestly, he's turned quite eccentric.
Eccentric?
Did you know he wanted to throw himself out of an airplane?
Mom, you mean suicide?
Oh, no, he tried to join a skydiving club. It was after that that he grew all that hair on his face and bought the sailor pants. Oh, he'd walk around the neighborhood, gotten up in that bohemian outfit, saying,
keep the faith, baby.
People we'd known for years, doing foolish things, trying to be young. He goes around acting as if he's 50. It's not funny. You know what he gave me for our 44th wedding anniversary? A miniskirt.
Did you wear it?
Of course not. One fruitcake in the family is enough.
Yeah. Must be some life. Out on the open road, ready for anything the world has to offer. Free as a bird. I've always wanted to be in the show business, you know. In my blood.
Why didn't you go into it, Grandpa?
Landed up in the plumbing business.
Was that in your blood, too?
No, son. I never really took to it. Hey, Danny, tell me about the applause. What is it really like to hear, huh?
It's nice when people show they like your work. It's like saying thank you for entertaining them.
Yeah. Heady stuff. Heady stuff.
Didn't anyone ever thank you after you unplugged the pipe?
Oh, sure. But they never exactly crowded into the bathroom, stomped up and down with their feet, and yelled for an encore. Just once, I'd like to experience that.
You certainly have the talent.
You're just not saying that because you want to make me feel good?
No. In my business, either you got it or you don't. You got it, Grandpa.
Danny boy.
Thank you.
I came to join the act.
What?
Well, you said that there was a spot open for me. Well, I've decided to take it.
Where's Mom?
I've left your mother, Shirley.
Left her?
The marriage just wasn't working out.
Dad, you've been married for 44 years.
Then was then, and now is now. She was trying to make an old man out of me.
But Dad...
I don't want to talk about it. From now on, it's a whole new life. Well, come on. Let's get the show on the road.
Well, we have to do something. We can't just hurt his feelings.
We could sabotage his mandolin.
What good would that do?
I don't know, but I bet mandolin parts are hard to get around here.
Look, let's not panic. I'm sure... Hello? Oh, yes, put her on. It's Grandma. Mom? Yes, he's here. Do you want to speak to him?
Of course I don't. I just want to find out if he got there without cracking his fool head in.
Mom, what's this all about?
He wanted me to go to Hawaii with him.
Well, what's so bad about that?
He wanted to go in a 20-foot sailing boat.
We exchanged some crosswords and...
At the end, he packed up all of his things and said he was running off to join the show business.
Look, Mom, I wouldn't worry too much. We have a long line of one-night stands ahead of us, and I'm sure after a few days of roughing it on the road, he'll be glad to come home.
Everybody's going places, doing things. Look at all the smiling faces, singing. Doing their numbers, getting it all together. Sound that's happening, and what we found is what we play and sing. Yeah, just doing our number, just getting it all together.
You know, I don't think your plan's working. Grandpa seems to be having a ball.
Yeah, what are we going to do when he wants to perform?
Well, he hasn't mentioned the idea lately. Maybe he's given it up. Come in.
I'm ready.
This month, you can go to McDonald's to check out the world's coolest cars. Not those cars, these cars. Or meet a bunch of cool new friends. Not those friends, these friends. Now kids can choose between a hip, hot, cool Barbie and Friends miniature with stylable hair or a tire-squealing, pavement-peeling new Hot Wheels car. One with each $1.99 hamburger Happy Meal you buy your kids. Eight of each to collect. Only at McDonald's. Not those McDonald's. This McDonald's.
This advanced technology helps to diagnose arthritis. But to effectively relieve the minor pain of arthritis, use this, Advil. Advil contains the number one doctor-prescribed ingredient in its class in non-prescription strength. Advil provides fast relief, and it works directly at the site of arthritis pain. And Advil is gentler on your stomach than aspirin. So for minor arthritis pain, trust Advil. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
Get back on the bus this Saturday night for Very, Very Nick at Night.
I'm David Cassidy, and I am there for you, Ben.
Yes, this Saturday at 10, 9 Central, Nick at Night brings you Very, Very David Cassidy.
I've chosen four episodes I think you're going to love. Some classic Partridge Family moments.
Watch Very, Very David Cassidy this Saturday at 10, 9 Central.
Only on Nick at Night. I'm sure it'll be very, very groovy.
I realize that I'm a raw and untested talent, and I have no desire to stand up and make a horse's...
make a fool of myself. So what I need is a cold, professional opinion.
But what happens if they don't like you?
Well, I'll be disappointed, of course. But I'll just have to take their word. I mean, if I'm going to be an entertainer, I want to be a good one. And not someone who you're having to carry because of nepotism.
What's nepotism?
Liking me because I am your grandfather.
I like you even if you weren't my grandfather.
Does anyone know someone who could look at my work?
Yes, Dad, I think we do.
Oh, good. I'll audition tomorrow afternoon and find out if I have a future in this business. Come on, kids. Let's go get some ice cream. Come on.
I don't believe it. We're off the hook.
I think so. Get Reuben on the phone.
Point me in thy direction of Albuquerque. I need to get home. Need to get home. What's the verdict?
I think it's the best thing I ever heard, Mr. Renfrew. Absolutely sensational.
That good?
It's beautiful. It's just so campy. The audience will eat it up. Oh, how can anyone resist the grandfather of the group trying to split the generation gap? Pure camp.
Then you think I should open tonight?
Mr. Renfrew, you can't miss.
Are you serious about
how
that?
Did you do such
I
a
could
thing?
Wait a minute.
He's going to go up. He's going to go up there and make a fool.
Wait a minute. Reached. Now, you did not tell me you wanted me to say he was rotten.
We didn't think we had to. I had no idea you were tone deaf.
Tone down, will you, kids? I'm trying to get your grandmother to come out for the opening.
I don't exactly think that's going to be a big treat for anyone.
I have a feeling he's going to need her. Hello, Mom?
I don't know why you're all so upset. Look, the act needs some comedy. Believe me, he'll go over like a house afire. He'll be hilarious.
I don't think that's what Granddad had in mind.
You're putting paint on your face?
Amanda, what are you doing here?
Oh, well, I heard tell that tonight you're going to sing and dance your way into the hearts of America with your electric mandolin.
And what's wrong with that?
Oh, nothing. If you're Ruby Keeler.
Amanda, you're not going to talk me out of this?
Oh, is there anything I could say that could?
No. Look, I'm sorry for a lot of things I said the other day. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized that all my life, whenever I wanted to strike out and do something exciting, you've talked me out of it.
Including buying tickets on the Titanic.
There you go again. Living in the past. What's the Titanic got to do with me making my debut tonight?
Well, they're both maiden voyages, and I think the other similarity is obvious.
No good, Amanda. We're incompatible.
It took you 44 years to realize that.
Okay. Maybe I was a little blinded by the physical thing we had going.
Now, just because you're in show business, there's no need for that kind of loose talk.
You know what's wrong with us, Amanda?
No, I don't.
We've got a generation gap.
Hi, Grandma. When did you get here?
I just got here, darling.
You aren't thinking of joining the act, too, are you?
No, dear. I'm only a spectator.
The story of Grandma's life.
What are you doing here in the dressing room, Grandpa? The show's not for 3 hours.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, I'm getting in the mood. Do you see my audition this afternoon?
No, the Dodgers are playing an afternoon game on TV.
Oh, I was a smash, son. Mr. Kincaid went on and on. What's campy?
Campy?
Yeah. See, I'm brushing up on all the show business lingo. What's campy?
Well, campy? Oh, that's something so corny that people laugh at it.
Laugh at it?
Yeah, sort of a put-on, making fun of something. See you later, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
Bye, Grandma.
You all right, Ted?
Of course I am. Just got a lot of things on my mind, that's all.
He found out what camping meant.
I really feel awful about this. Well, I thought he understood.
When Fred performed, he expected people to take him seriously, not to laugh at him.
Well, maybe if you told him you'd understand if he didn't go on, he...
Oh, he won't talk to anybody now. He won't listen to me, especially.
Well, I think I understand how you feel, Mrs. Renfrew. If it's any consolation, it'll only be for one night.
Reuben. He is my father. Foolishness and all. I don't want to see him humiliate himself. And I won't let him. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the newest and perhaps the youngest member of our group, my father, Fred Renfrew.
Excuse me, I have a request.
Now?
Would you play Bye Bye Blackbird?
Oh, for Pete's sakes, Amanda! These folks don't want to hear that old song.
Oh, well, you never know. They might like it. It was a song that Fred played when we were courting.
Amanda!
For me, Fred, please.
Pack up all my cares and woe, here I go, singing low, bye, bye, blackbird. Where somebody waits for me, sugar sweet, so is she. Bye, 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 blackbird. No one here can love and understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all have. Make my bed and light the lights. I'll arrive late tonight. Blackbird.
Bye,
bye,
bye, bye, bye, bye, bye.
Pack up all my cares and woe.
Here I go.
Singing low.
I'm singing bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Blackbird. Where somebody waits for me.
Sugar sweet.
Sugar sweet.
So is she.
So is she.
Bye.
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 Blackbird.
Fred, you were the one who did it. I just wanted you to see there's a place for the past.
Well, maybe I have been overdoing the youth kick.
It's not all your fault. You were acting like you were 25 years old and I was acting 95. It's just too big a gap.
So we'll close it. We'll build a bridge and meet somewhere near the middle.
Where?
How about splitting the difference? Somewhere in our mid-50s?
I think I can manage that. If you can mature that much.
We all know granola's great tasting, but there's another side to it. Fat. But Kellogg's low-fat granola has half the fat and all those big clumps of great taste. Kellogg's low-fat granola. For today's granola fans, great taste, half the fat.
The concert you've waited your whole life for.
Back on the bus tomorrow night and make a date with Nick at Night as the Partridge family spreads a little lovin' in four classic episodes all about L-U-V love.
It's human nature.
It's a full night of hot dates, adoring fans.
I didn't ask those girls to chase me.
And big questions.
Would you go steady with me?
So get back on the bus with the Partridge family tomorrow night at 8, 7 Central on Nick at Night.
Of course I'm glad Grandpa was such a smash, but we still have the same problem, you know.
What do you mean?
After last night, there'll be no stopping him.
I don't think so, Keith. You leaving, Grandpa?
Show him, Amanda.
Two tickets for around the world on a very large ship.
It's a compromise.
What about show business?
Oh, well, maybe if they coax me, I might do a couple of gigs on the ship's lounge.
I think she means a career, Grandpa.
Over. It was an experience I wouldn't have missed for the world. But now it's out of my system. I know I could have been a star. Now I've got a lot of other things I want to do.
Both of us want to do.
Right. Now say goodbye to the kids.
Goodbye, kids.
No, I mean, really say goodbye to the
darling
kids.
Bye,
goodbye,
kids.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Hey, play good. Sing good.
Goodbye, kids.
Goodbye, Grandpa.
Bye, Dad. Goodbye. Have a good time.
Goodbye.
Bye,
take care. Have a good trip, Grandpa. Bye.
Have a good time.
Goodbye.
Let's burn some rubber.
I am sitting on the sofa. There's a TV in the corner. I am watching Major Nelson. He is played by Larry Hagman.
Janie!
And he found a little bottle, and out popped Barbara Eden. But she couldn't show her belly button. All she did was blink.
Good evening, Major Nelson.
Tony Nelson works at NASA with suspicious Dr. Bellows. And there's also Roger Healy, who would become Howard Borden.
Jeannie!
And Jeannie always means well, but they get in wacky trouble. She folds her arms and blinks her eyes. It's kind of like Bewitched.
Jeannie!
Jeannie!
Yes, Master.
Oh, the reruns will continue on the TV as I'm watching the pink smoke of her bottle. I am dreaming of Jeannie.
Jeannie!
Da 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 da.
To fight gum disease, Colgate Precision has three sets of bristles. One like a flat brush for the surface, another like a rippled brush to reach between, and a third designed like nothing else to sweep plaque from the gum line. Fighting gum disease takes precision.
If your bacon cheeseburger isn't flame broiled, fire it.
Welcome to Burger King.
And get a new flame broiled
Bacon Mega Supreme.
The new Bacon Mega Supreme is a third pound of beef broiled over an open flame, and flame broiling beats frying 4-1. Two patties smothered in hot, crispy bacon, melted cheese, lettuce, and tomato. So if it's fried, it ought to be fire. Get the new flame broiled Bacon Mega Supreme. More great taste for more great value. Only at Burger King.
But no plan could be so smart as to pick one machine that plays Sega Genesis and Sega CDs. That's the JVC XI. She could care. Put your mind to work, she says. I say XI comes with Compton's Interactive Encyclopedia. Hey, it's a CD player. Plus you get stuff for free. So now let's see what you can do when you apply yourself. One mind, one machine. XI, multi-entertainment system. Call 1-800-JVC-XI.
Stuff. We all want stuff. And when we buy a new car, we want all the stuff. Dual airbags, power steering, power mirrors, air conditioning, a stereo, automatic transmission, a place to put a cup of coffee, convenience stuff. What's really great is that you can get all this stuff on any of these Escorts for the same low price. That's called value. Escort is a great value. Compared stuff to stuff to its leading competition, Escort costs less, period. Ford Escort. Good stuff, great price.
I suddenly got this idea for a new television series. You see, it would be about this kooky red-headed girl, you see?
Lucy?
Mrs. Carmen! And she works in a bank.
You have to work.
And she gets into all sorts of impossible situations. And forget it, nobody would ever believe it.
Nick at Night believes. Watch The Lucy Show every night on Nick at Night.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, is this where Flight 74 comes in from the east about 1201? Yes, ma'am. Oh, my girlfriend's on that plane. Vivian Bagley. I mean, her name used to be Vivian Bagley, but now it's Vivian Bunsen. She got married again.
Flight number 74 is now coming in for a landing.
Oh, there it is. Oh, isn't this exciting? Oh, look. Someone's hanging out of the plane. It looks like Viv.
the landing gear.
Flight number 74 will be unloading at gate 7.
Oh, miss, where are you going?
Oh, I just wanted to be back there. I thought it would be very nice if I was right there at the bottom of the steps when Viv came out of the plane.
I'm sorry, miss, but you can't go out there.
Oh, well, I won't be in the way. There's plenty of room.
Well, it's not a question of room. We've never had anyone run over by a plane. We'd like to keep it that way.
Oh, well, those are the rules. But I just can't wait to see Viv. Oh, I've got so much to talk with her about. You know, we haven't seen each other for over a year. There's Viv! There's Viv! Viv! Viv!
Oh, I don't know how I stayed away. I'm so...
Have you had breakfast?
Oh, no. I just had lunch.
Oh, I forgot the difference in time.
Oh, I love it. Now that I'm in California, I'm 3 hours younger.
Oh, and you look it.
And you just look absolutely wonderful.
Thank you.
And you're working for Mr. Mooney.
How about that?
How is he?
Same as ever.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear it. I thought California would agree with him.
Oh, I'm dying to hear about your husband.
Oh, and am I dying to tell you about him.
What does he look like?
Well, he's handsome.
Yeah.
He's tall, and he's got dark hair, and he has blue eyes.
You're kidding.
No. Oh, my gosh.
Oh,
he's
that's
so strong, and he has a lot of character. Just hates those marriages where the wife tries to run things, doesn't want the woman running things at all.
Oh, he's the boss, huh?
No, I am, but he hates it.
Oh, same old beer, that's my jar. Here, let me carry this for you.
Gee.
Oh, boy, that's heavy. What do you got in here?
A bunch of presents.
What?
A big bag of oranges.
Good morning, Mr. Mooney.
Good afternoon. I'm glad you finally got here.
Gee, have I got a big surprise for you.
Oh, please, please, no games. Not on the day.
Not waiting to find out who came to see us.
But
surprise!
Hello, Mr. Mooney.
Oh, my.
To come here because I didn't want her sitting alone in my apartment all day waiting for me, so I didn't think you'd mind if she waited until I finished work.
Well, not at all. Now, of course, you must excuse us. We have a lot of important work today.
Oh, don't mind me. Just go right ahead.
You sit right over here, darling.
Okay.
And you put your bags right over here. Take off your coat.
Oh,
here's
right?
A magazine. I just know you're going to love. There's some wild things in here.
Oh, righty?
Mrs. Carmichael,
yes, sir.
Will you bring your ledger over here,
yes,
please?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, will you refer to page 44?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, now, 44.
Oh, Lucy, look at this gown.
Look at that. That's the one, Viv. Is that too much?
Oh, of course, you have to have the figure for it. Oh, say, did you notice I've lost a lot of weight? I'm down to a size 12, and that's without my girdle.
Yeah, I sure did notice. I noticed that on the way home from the airport.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, we never had that much room in the cab before.
Since I got married, I just stopped eating between meals.
You did?
Yep. I just eat my 6 meals a day now, and that's it.
6 meals?
Uh-huh. I have to keep up my strength. If I don't, it gets a week, I can't eat. And if I can't eat, I don't have the energy for those singing lessons.
Oh, you're giving singing lessons?
Not giving, taking.
Oh, how wonderful. How are you doing?
Oh, wait till you hear me.
Not here.
All right, Mr. Mooney. But I want you to hear me before I leave town.
Oh, I want to hear you, Viv. I want to.
My husband refers to me as his happy little canary.
Ah, that's cute.
Cute? 150-pound canary?
Viv, would you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, I'd love to have a cup of coffee.
You don't mind, do you, Mr. Mooney?
Oh, it'll be just like old times having a cup of coffee with you.
Oh, and I got so much to ask you.
Oh, and I've got so much to tell you.
Have you?
Mm-hmm. Before I left home, I went to the beauty parlor and I picked up all the local gossip.
Oh, wonderful.
Anybody wants me, I'll be out in my car.
Mooney, aren't you going to stay and have coffee with us?
You're right. He hasn't changed a bit.
He sure hasn't. And I'm so glad he's gone. Now we can gossip all we want to. Tell me about everybody.
Well, now let's see. When I was in the beauty parlor, I heard something about Helen and Joe Walton's son.
You mean little Herbie Walton?
Yeah, you remember him?
Certainly. I was at his high school graduation.
Well, he came out here to go to college.
Yeah.
And I heard...
Yeah, what? What did you hear?
I heard that all he does is hang around that Sunset Strip.
Yeah?
Well, they said he's, he just got so he looks very unusual.
Like what?
Well, he's got hair down to his shoulders, and he's got a guitar hanging around his neck. And he wears a watch in his ear for an ear.
Well, never mind that. Tell me why he looks unusual.
I just told you. He's got hair down to here, and he wears a watch in his ear like an earring.
Well, on the Sunset Strip, everybody looks like that.
Well, maybe you folks out here in California are used to things like that, but, oh, boy, if his mother ever hears what happened to him.
Do you mean Helen doesn't know?
No, she doesn't go to my beauty parlor.
Well, maybe we better get up on that Sunset Strip and straighten out little Herbie before his folks hear about him.
Oh, now, Lucy, there's nothing we can do.
What do you mean there's nothing we can do? We can try to talk to him.
Oh, his generation lives in a kooky little world all their own. They don't want to talk to us.
Well, maybe he would talk to us if he sees us up there on the Sunset Strip and he thinks that we're his own kind.
Now, Lucy, we're outsiders. He wouldn't talk to us. Besides, I didn't come here to butt into anybody's business. I came here to see the sights.
Well, then you got nothing to worry about. You're going to see the Sunset Strip. And believe me, girl, that's a sight.
New Secrets 4-Hour Cough Drops help stop coughs far longer than menthol drops for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, up to 4 hours. New Secrets 4-Hour Cough Suppressant.
This is how water flows through clean drains. But over time, this gunky buildup slows drains down.
And buildup this tough needs special treatment.
Drano introduces the first buildup remover in professional strength.
The green means enzyme action that makes Drano Pro Strength better than other buildup removers. Get Drano Buildup Remover. The green means new Pro Strength. And go with the flow.
S.C. Johnson Wax.
She's sweet. She's hot. And now, she's here on the home of classic TV. Yes, Nick at Night loves Lucy. And to welcome her, we've selected 25 of the most unforgettable episodes of I Love Lucy, shown uncut and restored to their original beauty. So join us for this classic TV celebration. Watch Nick at Night loves Lucy all this week starting at 8, 7 Central.
They'd be this far out.
Oh, boy.
Did you see that cook with his beard in curlers?
Yeah.
How about that character with the bare feet and the braided toes?
Gee, I think I look just as ridiculous.
I don't see why I let you talk me into this.
Because we want to find Herbie Walton, don't we?
Well,
maybe one of those weirdos knows where we could find Herbie. But remember, they don't trust outsiders. Let's act like we're one of them. Come on. Just hang on a second.
Hi.
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 Hi. What's your name?
Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
Hi.
Oh, hi. Hi, I'm Vi. I'm Luce.
Luce?
That's short for Lucy.
First time you two chicks making a scene?
Yeah.
You belong to some cycle outfit?
Yeah.
Which one, the Cobras or the Sharks?
The Bloomer Girls.
The Bloomer Girls? I never heard of them.
It's an undercover outfit.
Well, what are you doing up here?
We're looking for a guy named Herbie Walton. Yeah.
Herbie Walton, huh? What's this cat look like?
Well, he's got long hair and a guitar, and he wears a watch in his ear like an earring.
Oh, yeah. You mean Itchy.
Itchy?
Yeah, Itchy usually makes a scene around this time. So stick around. Beautiful.
Thank you. He was talking to me.
Say, Harry.
Yeah?
Take a look at those new rules and see if I'm allowed to tell her to get her foot off my motorcycle.
It says here it's okay if you take your hat off first.
Excuse me, miss. Would you please get your foot off my motorcycle?
Ah, cool it, Bud. Cool it. Don't jabber. Don't jabber.
Don't jabber me. Don't jabber me.
Get your foot off my motorcycle.
Cool it, man. Cool it.
Now, cool it.
Don't blow your stack, pussycat. Don't blow your stack.
Oh, Lucy, I'm going to get out of here. I want to go home.
No, no, wait a minute. Wait a minute. We want to find Herbie Walton, don't we?
Well, I don't know.
Look. There's a lot of coops going into that club across the street. Let's start in there.
In the Harry, eh? Yeah, that should be a good place to find a guy named Itchy.
Oh, now, don't jab at me. Don't jab.
Don't blow your stack, pussycat. Don't.
Nobody's too young to play the Monopoly game.
Yeah, there's a Monopoly Junior game for kids just like you. It's all about a trip to the amusement park.
You get to buy and sell like Monopoly.
You can get rich.
Like Monopoly, the Monopoly Junior game. Specially designed for your kids 5 to 8.
Have a joyous holiday with Red Door, the sophisticated fragrance from Elizabeth Arden. Now, enjoy a special collection of travel-size Red Door treasures. Just $40 at the Elizabeth Arden counter.
Saturday, starting at 10, 9 central, only on Nick at Night.
New television programs getting you down?
Then say hello to your favorite shows. Just tune in to Nick at Night.
Hello out there from TV land.
Will it be?
What do you have? Can we have a menu?
We don't have menus. If you don't see it on the tablecloth, we ain't got it.
We'll just have some coffee.
Okay. Two muddy splashes.
We don't know any California dances.
What kind of dancing do you do?
Well, I can do the lighthouse.
The lighthouse?
Uh-huh.
What do you do?
I can do the chipmunk.
The chipmunk?
Yeah.
See, that was really cool. Entertainment. Got a new cat that wants to try his wings here at the Hairy Eight. Itchy Walton. He'll accompany himself on his own get box.
Isn't that awful? Look at that hair.
And his father a barber.
No wonder he's itchy.
I'm going to sing my own composition, Lament to a Small Town. I come from a small town with grass roots, blue serge suits, and turkey shoots. It's Squaresville, man, like new moon hay, or Groundhog's Day, or Friday night at the PTA. Yeah, the dialogue's dull as dull can be. They say things like, long time no see, or howdy neighbor, golly gee. Yeah, or a village fool when he blows his cool will come on with a, by Jiminy. Well, I split these scenes before my teens. Had to take my leave on Christmas Eve because I sealed Santa up in the chimney. I could hear him shout that he wanted out as I grabbed his sleigh for my getaway. On hipster, on swinger, on playboy, on bunny. Let's get to the city and go for the money. Merry Christmas.
The worst thing you ever heard?
Man, it'll probably sell a million copies.
Oh, Itchy, that was groovy, man, groovy. Yeah, we dig you, Cat. We'd like to buy you a splash.
Yeah, sit down, have a splash with us, Itchy.
Yeah, groovy, groovy.
You really come from a small town, Itch?
You better believe it. A place called Danfield. Real dope.
And when did you make up your mind to leave there?
Well, a while ago. Then I came out here with all these cats and I dug all this swinging action.
Well, don't you miss your parents or ever think about them?
Well, you know, they're okay, but that mom and dad scene is really a drag.
Yeah, that's
interesting. Not that they should be stamped out or anything, you know, but that Maggie and Jigs action is pretty hard to take.
Maggie and Jigs? Herbie Walton, you ought to be ashamed of yourself talking about your parents like that.
Herbie Walton?
Yes.
How do you know me?
I'm Mrs. Bunsen.
Mrs. Bunsen? From Danfield?
Yes, and this is Mrs. Carmichael. Maybe you remember her. She used to live there.
In Dolesville.
Well, yes, sure, but what are you two doing here?
Yes,
like this?
We're trying to find you, Itchy, and bring you to your senses.
Oh, well, now, Mrs. Carmichael, I was just putting you on.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I thought you were like all the rest of these characters, and I didn't want anybody to get wise to me.
Get wise to you?
Wise to you about what?
The hair and all this jazz. You don't really think I turned out to be one of these kooks.
Well, then what are you doing here like that?
I'm just getting some material that I need for a thesis.
A thesis?
Yes, for my psychology class.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Oh, believe me, I can't wait to take this wig off.
Oh, it's a wig. Oh, well, are we glad to hear that.
Listen, will you do me a favor?
Sure, what?
What time is it? Oh, my gosh, I gotta be cutting out.
What?
I mean getting back to the dorm.
The dormitory.
Nice to see you.
Oh, I'm so glad we found you, Herbie.
Good luck with your thesis.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. When I write Mom and Dad, I'll tell them I saw you. I won't tell them how you looked.
Oh. Well, now, aren't you glad we came? Everything turned out just fine.
Yeah, for once, one of your crazy schemes didn't backfire. Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Now we'll continue with our impromptu entertainers. Hey, Red! Do either of you chicks chirp?
Yeah, my friend does.
What friend does what?
You. I want you to chirp. Sing
oh,
a song.
I can sing here.
Sure you can.
I don't want to sing here, Lucy.
You said that you wanted me to hear you sing.
Well,
now,
I was thinking of the Hollywood Bowl.
No.
Or something. I couldn't sing. I gotta have somebody accompany me.
Well, I'm just dying to get my hands on this git box. Now, what are you gonna sing?
My best song.
Well, what's that?
I dream of Jesus, the light down here.
The wagon's waiting outside.
Well, what's the rap?
The curfew law.
The curfew?
Now, you kids know the rules. Everybody under 18 has to be in by 10 o'clock.
Under 18? Oh, now, listen, officer.
Vivian, let's not argue with a nice officer.
I hope Mumsy and Daddy aren't too upset by this.
It's Tote's remarkable small wonder. The full-size umbrella that folds up even smaller than other compact umbrellas. Which means the wonder of the small wonder is that you can keep it with you and take it anywhere. Tote's small wonder.
It folds up like a wonder and holds up like a totes.
It's common knowledge that the simple act of petting a dog can make people healthier and happier. It's even been suggested that people who own dogs lead longer, fuller lives. Now, knowing what dogs do for you, wouldn't it be nice to do the same for them? You can, by feeding your dog Iams every day. It's more nutritious because its quality ingredients are more digestible. Iams dog food, good for life, from the Iams Company.
The Genie Nod. Powerful. The Samantha Nose Twitch. Also powerful. And so the debate rages on whose powers are greater. Every night, Nick at Night brings classic TV's two most powerful women together, head-to-head and nose-to-nod. Who's more powerful? Judge for yourself every weeknight at 8, 7 Central on Nick at Night.
Swamis go for meditation.
Vampires need to bite.
But if you're hooked on classic TV,
you need Nick at Night.
This is the city, Los Angeles, California. The people here, like anywhere else, put in a hard day. After work, they want to get home. It can take 10 minutes or 2 hours. Once there, they like to unwind. They can go out to one of 560 movie theaters. For those who can't get a babysitter, there are 27 drive-ins. This is the city of the drive-in. Supermarkets, restaurants, dry cleaners, even banks. There are drive-in car washes, 125 of them. Life in Los Angeles is fast and convenient. It's a great place to live. I try to help keep it that way. I carry a badge.
The story you are about to see is true. The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
After you clean your floor, does it feel sticky? Try new Mop and Glow Floor Cleaner. It cleans in one step and doesn't leave a sticky residue, so there's no need to rinse. With new Mop and Glow No Rinse Floor Cleaner, you won't get stuck having to rinse.
Oh, menstrual cramps. Bloating? Tylenol did nothing for my bloating.
Midol does help.
My headaches. Tired. Advil didn't keep me from feeling worn out.
Tylenol and Advil only relieve pain. Maximum strength Midol relieves pain but adds an ingredient for fatigue and bloating.
I felt like myself again.
Midol helps it all go away.
With it. Real with it. Joe Friday is the now look.
Sure.
He's what's happening. Comes in two formulas, Mod and Ultra Mod. Joe Friday.
Keeping the faith, baby.
On Dragnet, every night on Nick at Night.
It was Tuesday, May 21st. It was clear in Los Angeles. We were working the day watch out of Homicide. The boss is Captain Hugh Brown. My partner's Bill Gannon. My name's Friday. Bill looked like he was practicing yoga. All right, I'll ask. What are you doing?
Oh, I was just practicing the paradox intention method.
The what?
The paradox intention method. You mean you never heard of it?
Oh, I can't say as I have.
It's very scientific. It's a new method of curing insomnia.
What's with the arms?
Oh, well, see, you raise your left arm like this. Then you say, my arm is heavy, heavy, heavy. And then you raise your right arm like this, and you say, my arm... Oh, that isn't necessary. I'm not going to do it now, Joe. Then you raise your left leg, and your right leg, and around the clock.
And then what happens?
Well, I just told you, pretty soon your arms and legs get heavier and heavier, and the next thing you know, you're sound asleep.
Let me ask you one thing.
Sure.
You just got to work, pal. How come you're trying to go to sleep?
Well, that's where the paradox intention comes in. The theory is that if you try to go to sleep, you'll stay awake, and vice versa.
I see. That's why it's called the paradox intention method.
That's why it's called that. If you try to do one thing, you'll do just the opposite. It's a paradox, Joe.
Does it work?
Well, sure it works. It's very scientific, you know.
Then how come you're yawning? You should have had a good night's sleep. Didn't you try your method last night?
Oh, yeah. I tried it.
Didn't work, huh?
No, it worked fine. The only trouble was it took all night to make it work.
Two people shot, man and a woman. Draft Grove printing plant in West Vernon. SID's on the way.
Right.
Looks like a sniper.
9:22 a.m. Grafco is a big plant in the May Park area. They print weekly newspapers and big circulation magazines. The payroll is about 200. 9:37 a.m. We arrived at Grafco. The personnel manager showed us the employment records of both victims. Fred Keller was a foreman, a family man. He got along with everybody. Barbara Hill was a secretary. She was well-liked. She had a fiancé overseas in the Air Force. 9:40 a.m. We talked to Frank Romero, the plant manager. He knew of no reason why anyone might have wanted to kill either of the victims. There were no witnesses. It appeared both victims were entering the building when they were shot.
You don't know of any quarrels the victims might have had, any bad blood with the other employees?
No, none. I can't believe anybody who works here could do a thing as horrible as this.
Mr. Romero, we'd like to have the names of any of your employees who didn't show up for work this morning.
Well, you think it was one of my employees?
It's a place to start.
Yes, of course. I'll get the timesheets.
Thank you.
I tell you, this has me all shook up. Two people shot down in cold blood. I suppose you people see a lot of this sort of thing. You're used to it.
No, sir. You never get used to it. Frank Romero came up with the names of six absentees. We checked them out. They all could account for their whereabouts at the time of the double murder. There was nothing to do now but begin the tedious job of checking out every man and woman on the Grafco payroll. We worked all day and into the night. Wednesday, 10:05 a.m. Bill and I checked back in after a short night's sleep. We had worked half the night at Grafco without turning a single lead. The bodies of both shooting victims were posted. Two slugs were removed from the male victim's head and one from an almost identical location in the female victim. The slugs were sent up to ballistics for identification.
Captain, Joe. Ballistics report, murder weapon was a .22 caliber rifle. Homicide, Helder. Yeah, for you, Joe.
Thank you. This Friday. Yes, sir. I see. All right, thank you, Mr. Romero. We're on our way. It's one of the foremen out at Grafco. He remembers a beef between the male victim, Fred Keller, and some kid, a college boy who works part-time.
Yeah?
Kid didn't show up for work yesterday, but nobody bothered to mark it down. 10:28 a.m. The foreman was named Al Souza. He said the boy who didn't show up Tuesday morning was named Jeff Buckram, 18 years old, a student at May Park Junior College.
He's kind of a flunky, Sergeant. He only works part-time when he hasn't got a class in college, and nobody remembered it was his day on, I guess.
You say he had a quarrel with Keller.
Wasn't much, hardly anything. 2 weeks ago, the kid fired up one of the big rotary presses. He's not supposed to even touch it. Keller jumped him, not too hard. Kid had it coming. It's dangerous fooling around with a big press like that. But the kid blew. He sort of turned white-like and doubled up his fist and started moving at Keller.
What happened then?
Nothing. One or two of the boys told him to cool it, and Keller just shrugged and said, take it easy, kid, or something like that.
And that was it?
Yeah, Keller walked away. Kid just stood there with his knuckles white, and everybody left him alone.
All right, thank you, Mr. Souza.
Well, I'm sorry, Sergeant, about not remembering yesterday, I mean. Kid like that, nobody ever seems to miss him.
Maybe that's what he didn't like. 'Frank Romero, the manager, gave us a copy of Jeff Buckram's personnel card with his home address, but he said we'd probably find the boy at school. He also gave us a good description of Jeff. 10:42 a.m., we drove over to May Park Junior College. 11:03 a.m., we checked with the registrar. Jeff Buckram was scheduled for an English class from 10 to 11 a.m. We decided to talk to his instructor. His English teacher was Ann Tipton.
Oh, you didn't miss Jeff. He was absent today. I knew something must be wrong.
Why do you say that, Miss Tipton?
He's never absent. What is it anyway? What's Jeff done?
Would you know the names of any of his friends?
No, Jeff spends most of his time alone. He's a very dedicated student, perhaps too dedicated.
How's that, Miss Tipton?
It's just a phase he's in, I suspect. He's a very sensitive young man, rather a poet. He's trying very hard to be an existentialist at the moment. He's 18, but he's still an adolescent. It's not a very good combination, adolescence and existentialism.
What do you mean by existentialism?
If you don't know, don't worry, Mr. Gannon. Nobody else knows either. It's sort of an anti-philosophy, really. Existentialists don't agree with each other about anything, even about being existentialists. But they do seem to have one thing in common.
What's that?
I'd say they're preoccupied with the darker side of life.
The darker side? Meaning what, Miss Tipton?
Oh, aggression, violence, fear, death. And there's one sort of central thing.
What's that?
They believe one should live one's philosophy, not just think about it.
Yes, ma'am.
One must act.
At 11:32 a.m., Jeff Buckram lived in a small two-story apartment with the usual palm trees out front. A weary-looking woman answered the door. She said she was Jeff Buckram's aunt, Ada Beale. We identified ourselves and she asked us in.
What do you want with Jeff? He's never had any trouble with the police.
You want to ask him some questions?
Well, he's in his room with his nose in the book, as usual. I've raised that boy since his folks was killed 8 years ago, but I never taught him to read trash like that. As God is my judge, I didn't.
What kind of trash is that, Miss Beale?
Flowers of evil, that's what it is. Baudelaire, you should hear him spout that stuff. It's profane, if you ask me, enough to drive the Lord right out of this house.
Aunt Ada thinks that all literature stops with the Bible. Anything else is blasphemous. Are you cops?
Jeff Buckram.
That's right. What have I done? Did Aunt Ada turn me in for reading Baudelaire?
This is Officer Gannon. My name's Friday, Los Angeles Police Department. We're investigating a shooting at the Grafco plant yesterday morning. Two people killed.
Yes, I heard about it on the radio. Aunt Ada's radio. I hate radios myself all day long, that hideous outpouring of vulgarity.
You weren't at work yesterday morning, Jeff. You mind telling us where you were?
Right here in my room, with my friend Flaubert.
Flaubert?
Oh, yes. Flaubert. It's another one of them flowers of evil.
You know Flaubert, officer?
Passing acquaintance.
Well, this is where I was all day yesterday. Right here, deep in the cesspools of French literature.
Can you verify that, Mrs. Beale?
Well, no, not directly, I can't. I wasn't home. But he was here, all right. Jeff never lies, even if his mind is poisoned against the Lord. I was at work. I'm a housekeeper odd days. It's the only kind of work the Lord fitted me to do.
Any special reason why you didn't go to work yesterday or to school today?
I'm in pain.
Is that so?
Yes, I took a line drive on the shin Monday. Baseball practice. I'm a pitcher.
College team?
That's right. May Park Junior College Pirates. Now, how is that for vulgarity?
We understand you knew Fred Keller, is that right?
That scum, illiterate scum.
Oh, God forgive us. Now you see what I mean, officers.
We understand you had a quarrel with Fred Keller 2 weeks ago. Tell us about it.
A quarrel?
You switched down one of the presses you weren't supposed to touch, isn't that it?
Keller was arrogant.
All right. Do you own a .22 caliber rifle?
Rifle? Do you want to search the place? Or would that prejudice your case?
For now, we're just asking, Jeff.
All right, you asked.
Do you own a rifle?
Am I under arrest?
No, you're not.
Well, all right, then I'll tell you the truth. No, I do not own a rifle. Anything else I can do for you?
Yeah. Stay home and take care of that sore leg.
What do you think?
I think he's lying.
So do I. There's somebody who might fill in a few blank spots for us.
Well, we already talked to his English teacher.
When you want to find out about a boy, you don't talk to his English teacher.
Is that right?
You talk to his baseball coach.
11:45 a.m. We spoke to Jeff Buckram's baseball coach, Jake Mahler.
Says he got a shin bruise at practice Monday.
Yes, sir.
This Monday.
That's what he says.
Jeff Buckram hasn't suited up for 2 weeks. Told me he had to quit baseball, so we dropped him from the squad.
What can you tell us about the boy?
I never could figure him out, really. I don't know why he came out for baseball in the first place. He didn't seem to have the normal motivation.
How do you mean?
No team spirit. He didn't care about anybody else. Like the team didn't exist. The only time he looked alive was when he was batting or pitching. The rest of the time he sat on the bench, usually reading a book.
What kind of books would you know?
You mean the titles?
Yes, sir, that's right.
Well, I wouldn't have any idea. All I can say is they weren't comic books.
Was he any good, Coach?
Any good? How do you mean?
Well, did he have any baseball talent? Was he a starter?
Yeah, he had the makings of a pretty fair pitcher. Good arm, aggressive, great fastball. That wasn't quite enough, though.
How do you mean?
Control. He'd go ape under any kind of pressure. He beamed the boy a couple of months back. I still don't know if he meant to or not. Like I told you, he could throw a ball like a bullet, but you never could be sure who or what he's going to throw it at.
When Jeff said he was quitting, did he give a reason?
All I remember is he said he had to work longer hours, earn more money.
Did he say what he wanted the money for?
Said he wanted to buy himself a rifle. I asked him if he was going hunting.
What did he say to that?
He just looked right through me and said, maybe I am. I sure hope he can aim a rifle better than any can of baseball.
Maybe he can.
For everyone you see, there may be 15 or 20 that you don't see, and they eat in many different places. A very unhealthy situation. But put Decon Mouse Proof in the places mice feed, like behind the refrigerator, the cupboard, the washer, and you'll eliminate them faster. Decon Mouse Proof gets mice right where they live.
Never miss a good piece of gossip. Look for hope everywhere. Know that work is good, and labor is even better. And always, always have an easy-to-use Olympus Stylus Zoom camera with you, so that you can capture the moments to embarrass your kids for the rest of their lives. Olympus, never miss another O.
Attention all chaos agents. Come in, counterintelligence. Surveillance of Get Smart now begins at 9, 8 Central.
What time?
9, 8 Central. Get Smart. Weeknights on Nick at Night.
Oh, what a desert the TV dial plays is. Nick at Night is a tropical oasis. Good TV refreshes you and me.
Nick at Night!
1:27 p.m. By now, we had probable cause for Jeff Buckram's arrest. We went downtown for arrest and search warrants and drove back to Jeff's apartment.
Oh, it's you. Jeff ain't home.
Gone. Not here.
How long has he been gone?
Packed up and run off the minute you folks left.
Did he say where he was headed?
He didn't even say, God bless me. He took my car. I couldn't stop him. Now, how am I going to get around without a car?
Did he take a gun with him, a rifle?
A gun? There's never been a gun in this house, Mr. Policeman.
What kind of car do you drive?
What kind? Blue. A Ford. A blue Ford.
What model?
Model?
What year's the car?
Well, I bought it secondhand. I don't know how old it is.
Well, do you know the license number?
How would I know that? It isn't even paid for yet.
Better get out an APB. I'll use the phone in the hall.
Right. Now, Mrs. Beale, do you have any idea where your nephew is?
I know what you're talking about, officer. I heard you ask about that shooting, and you think Jeff did it.
Yes, ma'am. We have a warrant for his arrest.
It's all over. I tried. Lord knows I tried. The devil is in this house. That boy, he talked with the devil. There, that book right where he left it. He tore a page out before he threw it there on the table.
Would you know why?
Just tore a page out and stuffed it in his pocket and left this house. I wouldn't know. I never read evil books.
We'd like to take the book with us, Mrs. Beale. It'll be returned after we finish our investigation.
Don't you bring it back here.
I beg your pardon?
It belongs to the public library. Return it to them if you want.
We'll do that.
Maybe you won't.
How's that?
It's overdue. You'll have to pay a fine.
We gave the apartment a thorough search. We failed to turn any kind of weapon. Before we left, we requested that the Buckram apartment be placed under surveillance. 1:55 p.m. The APB went out on Jeff Buckram and the blue Ford. The only thing we had to go on was the book. We drove over to the branch library Jeff had checked it out from. The senior librarian was Alice Philbin. Talk to her in the coffee room.
I don't like to receive visitors in the main room. It's difficult enough to maintain quiet without our setting a bad example.
Yes, ma'am.
Miss Philbin, do you know a Jeff Buckram?
Jeff Buckram, yes, I do. He's one of our best customers.
Here's a book he borrowed. I believe it's one of yours.
Oh, yes, Flaubert. It's overdue, Sergeant.
There's a page missing. Page 67. It's been torn out.
That's not like Jeff.
How do you mean?
Well, he loves books. Overdue, yes, that's Jeff. But vandalism, no.
We'd like to know what was on that page. Can you help us?
Well, I know you haven't come here just to return an overdue book and report a torn page. Jeff Buckram's in some kind of trouble. What is it?
We'd like to talk to him. Do you have another copy of that book?
Yes, I believe we do have one more copy. If it's in, I'll check.
We'd appreciate that.
It's probably on the shelf. Flaubert isn't very big in this neighborhood. I was right. It's funny you should tear this particular page out.
How's that, ma'am?
It's about a boy who loves to kill things.
Yes, ma'am.
He starts out killing a little mouse, and finally he kills his father and mother. This is page 67. I'll read it to you. One morning, as he was going back along the curtain wall, he saw a fat pigeon on the top of the rampart preening itself in the sun. Julian stopped to look at it, and as there was a breach in this part of the wall, a fragment of stone lay ready to his hand. He swung his arm, and the stone brought down the bird, which fell like a lump into the moat. He dashed down after it, tearing himself in the briars and scouring everywhere, nimbler than a young dog. The pigeon, its wings broken, hung quivering in the boughs of a privet. The obstinate life in it annoyed the child. He began to throttle it, and the bird's convulsions made his heart beat, filled him with a savage, passionate delight. When it stiffened for the last time, he felt that he would swoon.
Thank you very much, Miss Philbin.
Gentlemen.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't judge too soon.
How do you mean?
Do you know how it turns out, the Flaubert story?
No, ma'am, we don't.
It's one of his most famous short pieces. In the end, despite all he's done wrong, the boy turns out to be very good.
Is that right?
Oh, yes. It's the legend of St. Julian.
p.m. We checked with the office. There were no results on the APB. Bill and I drove back to May Park Junior College. We wanted to talk to Ann Tipton again, Jeff Buckram's English teacher. She said she was familiar with the legend of St. Julian.
Oh, yes, I'm familiar with the legend of St. Julian. It's regarded as one of the most lucid and graphic stories ever written on the joy of killing.
Was this a particular favorite story of Jeff Buckram's?
I'm no psychiatrist, believe me. I guess I've been trying to talk like one. I'm really nothing but a junior college English teacher, and a rather frightened one at that.
Well, why is that?
I'm frightened for Jeff Buckram. And I'm afraid for Nancy Morton, too.
Nancy Morton, now who's she?
You might say she's Jeff's girlfriend, but I don't know that she'd agree with you.
What do you mean by that?
I doubt if Jeff has had much experience with sex. He's rebelling against everything, including sex, I imagine. He needs somebody to lean on, to idealize.
Well, now, why didn't you tell us about the Morton girl before?
I didn't think it was important before, and I just didn't want to get anyone involved. Now I'm beginning to get concerned for Nancy.
Why is that?
I think Jeff's trying to escape into some fantasy world, but he can't quite go it alone. He wants to take somebody with him. Something else about that world of his.
Yes, ma'am.
It must be a very dark place.
Nancy Morton wasn't at school. We got her home address from the registrar's office. She appeared nervous, but she asked us in when we said we wanted to talk about Jeff Buckram.
What is it? Is Jeff in some kind of trouble?
We'd like to ask you a few questions, Miss Morton. How well do you know Jeff Buckram?
He's just a friend. I'm not sure what the relationship is, really. We're not that friendly. What is it anyway? What's happened to Jeff?
We're trying to locate him, Miss Morton. Now, did you and Buckram spend much time together?
No, nothing like that. He's never even tried to kiss me. He's just somebody I know, that's all.
Is that so?
I suppose every red-blooded college girl expects to be made a pass at sooner or later. Jeff's just different, that's all.
How's he different?
He just wants to talk, or sit and look at me, or out the window. He recites poetry sometimes. Although I admit it's pretty gloomy stuff. You know, Baudelaire, Rimbaud, that stuff. We met in English Lit. He isn't too bad-looking, and he seems so intellectual.
When did you see him last?
Just a few minutes before you arrived.
Where'd he go?
I don't know. He didn't say.
Did he seem nervous or upset?
No. I didn't notice anything special. He's always sort of different. I wish you'd tell me what we're talking about. Has Jeff done something?
We'd like to ask him some questions. Have you any idea where he might be? Any places he's known to frequent? Any friends he might visit?
I don't know of any of his friends or even if he has any.
I see.
He seems so helpless. Like he had to have somebody to be near. But he didn't want any involvement. It was like he wanted somebody to own, but he didn't want anybody to own him or even touch him. All he believed in was people and books, people that don't exist. He believed in ideas that didn't have anything to do with anything real, anything in his own life. It was like he lived in a world made up of other people's words.
All right, Miss Morton, thank you. You've been very helpful. Now, we just have one more question for you. Why did Buckram stop by here this afternoon?
Do I have to tell you?
Yes, ma'am, you do.
He stopped by to pick up something.
What was it?
A gun.
What kind of a gun?
I don't know. I don't know anything about them.
Did he get it?
Yes.
Can you tell us what the gun looked like? Was it a rifle, a pistol?
It was a rifle. I know that much.
Do you know what caliber?
Caliber?
That's the diameter of the bore. Now, did he say what caliber it was?
I don't know. What could he have said? What would it sound like?
Well, 30-30, 30-06.
Yes. He said 22. Does that mean anything?
4:15 p.m. Bill and I went back to the office. Nancy Morton's home was placed under surveillance.
Homicide, Gannon. Yeah, he's right here.
This Friday. Yes, Miss Philbin. No, don't go near him. If he starts to leave, try and stall him. Leave him alone. That's right, we're on our way. Jeff Buckram, he's at the library. We drove as fast as the traffic would allow across town to the May Park Branch Library.
Cops in a library? Aren't you out of your milieu?
You're under arrest for murder.
I've been patient too long. My memory is dead. All fears and all wrongs to the heavens have fled, while all my veins burst with a sickly thirst. That's Rimbaud, officer.
And these are your rights. Listen to them. You have the right to remain silent.
Murder?
Give up the right to remain
I had
silent.
No idea, Sergeant. Say, Cannon, we'll be do you think Flaubert was the reason?
No, ma'am. The right not the reason. Just the excuse. Ada Beale's car was found in an alley near the library. The .22 caliber rifle was in the trunk. It was checked out and confirmed by SID as the murder weapon. Jeff Buckram said he didn't want a lawyer.
I shouldn't have done it.
Shouldn't have done what?
Torn that page out. That was wrong.
So's murder.
Flaubert wasn't right, you understand. He didn't really know.
Is that so?
Wasn't like that at all.
Wasn't like what?
Like he said, full of delight. Savage and passionate delight. I didn't feel anything like that at all.
What did you feel?
I felt scared, like when you break something. Something that belongs to somebody else. And you know you gotta get caught. And you gotta get punished. I guess I'll never make it, will I?
Make what?
I guess I'll never be a saint like Julian and Flaubert.
You got a long way to go.
Over, so's the party. That's why Magnavox makes a great sounding mini system that plays 7 CDs for over 8 hours of non-stop music. Hey, we make technology people want. Magnavox, smart, very smart.
With sheer energy, you're ready for anything. Because you're never quite sure where the day is going to take you. Sheer energy from legs goes wherever you need it to. It's strong. It's sheer. It's beautiful. And with sheer energy, you'll have the energy you need once you get to your next destination. Sheer energy from legs. It's amazing how far you can go in a great pair of pantyhose.
Here are three classic TV scenes which don't appear to have anything in common. But let's look at them again with Nick at Night's Classic TV Rewind. On repeated viewing, it appears that the same bearded gentleman is in three separate TV series. Is this the hardest working extra in Hollywood? No, it's James L. Brooks, creator of The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Taxi, and Rhoda, and therefore the highest paid extra in Hollywood. Classic TV Rewinds, a second look at shows that are always worth a second look on Nick at Night.
If you suffer from the late night TV blues, it's Nick at Night for the deja views.
All night, every night.
The story you have just seen is true. The names were changed to protect the innocent. On July 16th, trial was held in Department 184, Superior Court of the State of California for the County of Los Angeles. In a moment, the results of that trial.
He has his own baseball coach.
Nice hitting, Richie.
Thank you, Mr. Jackson.
His own theme park and personal trainer.
Hi, Richie.
Yikes.
But he's about to discover what he needs most is friends.
The place probably's got its own zip code. It must be cool to have everything.
You can join the world's richest kids on the world's most incredible adventure.
Mom!
Macaulay Culkin. Richie Rich. Rated PG. Starts Wednesday, December 21st.
When I started Toys R Us 45 years ago, I had a vision. Great toys for less money. I realized this dream. My low price guarantee. That if you can find a toy advertised at a low price, anywhere, anytime, we'll match it. I'll guarantee it. Or my name isn't Charles Lazarus.
Hi, Ben.
Hi, Uncle Charles.
Well, he's right about one thing. We do guarantee our low prices.
Toys R Us will match any advertised price, guaranteed.
In this scene from I Dream of Jeannie, Don Rickles plays a tough physical fitness instructor. He leaves the room in order to retrieve some special workout gear for Major Nelson and Major Healy. But let's look at this again using Nick at Night's classic TV Rewind. On repeat viewing, one can see that Rickles hasn't gone anywhere. This no-talent hockey puck is actually standing in plain view waiting for his cue to return. Classic TV Rewinds, a second look at shows that are always worth a second look on Nick at Night.
The jury found the suspect guilty on two counts of first-degree murder. Murder in the first degree is punishable by death or confinement in the state prison for life.
Coming up on Nick at Night, it's Alfred Hitchcock Presents, followed by The Lucy Show, and then F Troop. Nick at Night, preserving our television heritage.
If your boss is a jerk and you get home from work and you feel like a troglodyte, there's instant relief from this hardship and grief.
Thank goodness for Nick at Night.
And now, tonight's Hitchcock tale, uncut, on Nick at Night.
And welcome to the Alfred Hitchcock Hour. With trailer camps springing up at every corner and all America taking to the road, I thought you might be interested in this, the latest in trailers. This model is a superb gasoline saver, for it comes complete with this lovely violin, a set of earrings, and two stolen horses. I see it is time for you to face the music. Here it is, after which we shall view tonight's story.
You get older, and your body starts to feel it. You get smarter, and you know the difference between pain relievers. That's why you get Bayer, the wonder drug, not Tylenol. Both relieve pain, but Bayer aspirin does something Tylenol can't. Only Bayer relieves the inflammation of arthritis when taken regularly. Just ask your doctor. You get older, you get smarter, you get Bayer.
We're challenging shoppers to compare X14 soap scum remover to Lysol.
The Lysol left to places where it didn't come off at all. But the X14 soap scum remover did get it all off in one wipe. I just wiped and it's gone.
color guard bleach will knock it out cold. Dirt goes, color stays.
He's a legendary director, erudite host, a faithful companion. He's Nick at Night's Alfred Hitchcock, top dog in TV land since 1955.
Daddy couldn't, darling. He had to talk to some parents.
It's vacation time, isn't it?
I know. Daddy always has to think of next term. These parents might send their son to another school.
I wish he could see my castle.
It's a beautiful castle. It's a beautiful day. We have the whole beach to ourselves.
No, we don't. There's a man out there.
Man?
Yeah. Out there.
Well, he has some nerve. I thought I had the whole Pacific Ocean reserved today.
Mom, can I go in the water once more?
Oh, all right, Tony, but be sure to stay in the shallow part.
Okay, toss me my ball.
Too far out! Tony! Tony, come back now!
Mom!
Mom! Tony! Tony! Tony!
Mom!
Tony! Go back! Go back! I'll get him!
It's all right. He's all right. He's all right.
I don't know how to thank you.
Please don't even try.
Oh, Tony, I don't know whether I should hug you or spank you.
Right now, I think you better dry him. I'll be right back.
Oh, Tony, are you cold, dear?
Lenny.
How you doing? What were you trying to do, swim to Hawaii?
I told him to stay near the shore. Oh, I'm very grateful. I can't swim. If you hadn't been there...
Well, I'm only glad I could help.
I'm Sally Mitchell. And this awful boy is Tony, though I don't know if you should even talk to him.
Hi, Tony.
Hi.
Say, you're cold, aren't you?
Yes, I am, rather.
Well, it's a natural reaction.
Thank you.
I recommend an old Air Force, really. Slip out of that wet suit into a dry martini.
I think I'd just as soon soak in a long, hot bath.
Are we going home?
Yes.
Well, let me help you with your things.
Oh, thanks.
Here you are, Colonel.
There you go.
Here, Tony. Do you have any of my shoes, dear, please?
Here, let me take those things.
Oh, thank you. Thanks. Didn't you bring your car?
I'm afraid I couldn't.
I haven't got one.
Oh, do you have far to go?
I'm staying at the edge of one.
Please, let me drive you.
No. You need that hot bath. Besides, I can still get a couple of hours more sun.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Hey, Tony, stay out of deep water now, here.
Okay.
I don't know what's the matter with me. I can't just drive out of your life after what you've done.
You said thanks. That's all that's necessary.
No, it isn't. My husband will want to meet you and talk with you. Perhaps you could have dinner with us tomorrow night.
All right, thanks. I'd love to.
We'll pick you up at the Edgewater at 7.
Fine.
Oh! Wait a minute. I don't even know your name.
Roscoe. Ray Roscoe. I guess the trouble is I began to take that off we go into the wild blue yonder stuff too seriously. Especially the off we go part. Made me restless. Thank you. Anyway, I couldn't see staying in the Air Force until I was too old to do anything else.
So you quit after 12 years' service. Takes a lot of courage to make a decision like that.
I can't say that I've ever regretted one minute of it. But then I've only been out 3 weeks.
Well, what are you going to do now?
No, thanks. I'm looking for a little place of my own. Somewhere where I can sit on the front porch and prop my feet up and watch the oranges drop out of the trees.
John, aren't the Richardsons in the orange business?
Yes, they own one of the largest groves in the county. They ought to know if there's any land for sale.
Well, it'll have to be a pretty small piece from what I've seen around here. Even on flying pay, you can't save very much money in the Air Force. Oh, the liquor and the cigarettes are cheap enough, but the poker is terribly expensive.
I'll call Phyllis Richardson first thing in the morning. See if she has any ideas. Oh, Kira, this is Mr. Roscoe.
Hello, Kira.
How you do, sir?
Kira's from Norway. She just came over last year.
Dinner will be ready in 5 minutes, Mrs. Mitchell.
Thank you, Kira.
You know, I've been thinking. If you do find a place you like, how are you going to finance it?
I'll have to get a loan if I can.
Look, you did something pretty important for me. If you need a loan, I'd be glad to help.
I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Well, for one thing, I'm sure it isn't any easier saving money teaching than it is flying.
Sally and I own this school. We built it up ourselves. It was a struggle at first, so I know what it's like getting a start. But it's quite a thriving place now. I think we can manage
$5,000. $5,000? Wow. Well, that's most generous of you. But no thanks. I prefer to do it on my own.
Well, how are you going to look for an orange grove without a car?
Well, I got 4 fingers and a thumb. I've also got some pretty big ideas, too, haven't I? Here I am one step away from being a beachcomber, and I'm talking about blithely sailing around the country looking for a beautiful orange grove. Oh, I can hitchhike, all right. I should be hitchhiking down to the employment office looking for a job. You know, the world gets to look very small looking down from a plane. Like you could handle it easily. But it gets pretty big when they clip your wings.
Pilot to tower, pilot to tower. Clear for landing.
Tower to pilot, tower to pilot. Clear for landing. Over.
Roger.
Let me try it, Uncle Ray. Let me. Boy, you really made her fly.
Girls don't care much about flying airplanes, do they, Kira? Tell you what, why don't we play hide and seek?
Let me be it, Uncle Ray.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here I come.
I guess we should be grateful that he keeps Tony amused. Tony is just crazy about him.
What about you?
Me? Well, he's very charming. It's just that he's been here 3 weeks already.
It's our idea, Sally. We invited him.
Has he mentioned anything to you about orange groves lately?
Not since he looked at the place that the Richardson suggested. He said it was too big for him.
Don't you have the feeling he isn't looking very hard?
Sally, you know how I feel about Ray. He did something for me I can't ever forget. Sometimes I wake up in a sweat thinking what could have happened.
Oh, I'm grateful too, John.
Got you, Uncle Ray. Now you're it. You're it.
Okay. Everybody hide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here I come, ready or not.
Gotcha. Kira, you don't understand American games. You lose, I win. And the winner always collects.
Fisher-Price, we believe there's a time for fun.
Let's visit the post office.
And a time to learn.
Find C.
It's called childhood.
You're right. Find 4 o'clock. Very good.
Which is why we've put so much fun into all our new electronic learning toys.
I'm Dinosorter. Take out the number 3.
Introducing right. Talking Dinosorter and Talking Smart Street. Just 2 of the Fisher-Price electronic learning toys designed to improve the learning curve.
Count the reasons you need a Presto Fry Daddy deep fryer. Perfect frying temperature, cups of oil, not quarts, non-stick finish inside and out, store oil to use again, handy scoop, not a messy basket, and the food delicious. Presto deep fryers.
Do you want me to talk to him?
No, I guess it's better coming from me.
Hi. Something wrong?
I want to talk to you. Would you like a beer?
No, thanks.
It's about Kira. It seems you've been making a pass at her.
Kira been complaining?
No. It's Sally.
Oh, come on, John. Don't tell me your wife's been spying on me. I didn't know she cared.
Tony saw you in the summer house.
And what did Tony say that he saw? Mind if I ask him?
I want Tony kept out of this.
Okay.
Kira's very young. We're responsible for her. If anything happened...
Oh, John, we were just having a little harmless fun. You know how it is. Or maybe you don't. You've got your honor to think of and the position of the school.
So long as you're here, I want that girl left alone.
Okay. Kira isn't the only well-shaped pebble on the beach. Class dismissed?
Yeah.
Good. I think I'll take the car out and check on an orange grove.
Anybody hurt? Well, I'm glad of that anyway.
What is it?
It's Ray. He's had an accident. Well, the policy's right here in my desk. All right, I'll bring it out then.
What happened?
Nothing very serious, but the other driver's kicking up a row. He wants to see our insurance policy. Guess he doesn't take Ray's word for it.
What'd you expect me to do? Run off the road just so that you could pass me?
Well, I could have sworn you had more room on the right.
You hadn't been in such a hurry.
Here he is now. John.
John, I'm sorry about this.
Are you the owner of this car?
Yes, my name is John Mitchell. This is my wife, Sally. Mr. Roscoe is our house guest.
Yeah, so he told me. I should think you'd be more careful who you lent your car to. He came racing up behind us.
This is Mr. and Mrs. Sherston from Washington, D.C.
And you can tell by the tire marks I was well to the right.
It was just an accident, George. Nothing to get heated about. Why don't we go inside and have a drink and talk this over calmly?
I think that's a fine idea myself.
So do I.
Well, I guess you're right. Damage is done. No good getting into an uproar.
Did you drive all the way from Washington?
Yes, and we've had a wonderful trip. George has been saving up his leave for 3 years. So we have 4 whole months vacation this summer.
Oh, this is wonderful.
You're our first guest.
You have a bedroom, living room, something. It's like a real home.
You work for the government, Mr. Sherston?
Internal Revenue.
Ouch.
Well, I have nothing to do with collecting taxes. I'm a statistician.
You just figure out how much you need and let the other boys collect it, eh?
One thing about working for Uncle Sam. Just a few more years and George gets a pension.
Well, sit down, make yourselves comfortable.
Thank you. I'll go fix the drinks.
Well, let me help you.
Do you plan to stay in California?
If we can find a nice quiet spot around here.
Well, even I don't like trailer camps much. We prefer to be off on our own.
I don't blame him.
We've heard of a place in the woods a few miles north of here that sounds ideal for a week or two.
By the way, before I forget, here's the name of my insurance agent.
Oh, thank you.
Here we are.
Thanks.
Well, what should we drink to? No more accidents?
To the nicest people I ever bumped into.
What's the matter?
Oh, I'm sorry, John. I had a terrible time getting Tony off of day camp this morning. He doesn't want to do anything anymore without his Uncle Ray.
Where's Kara?
In her room, brooding. She knows you talked to Ray about her, or them, or...
He probably told her.
She practically accused me last night. Oh, it's so ridiculous. Of being jealous of her.
I'll get it. Hello? No, he is not here. Oh, hello, George. What? What happened? Well, that's terrible. Hasn't he any idea of how to behave? All right, George.
Is that George Sherston?
Yes.
About the insurance?
He's so mad he could hardly talk. Ray's been pestering his wife.
Oh. No.
He drove out of the trailer the other night while George was away and made a pass at Eve.
Well, I'm not surprised. I saw the way he looked at her in the trailer.
What's the matter with him? First he manhandles Kira, now Eve. The next one may be you.
I think it's time Ray found another place to live.
Don't worry. I'm still grateful, but... there's something very wrong about this guy. I'm uneasy every minute he's around.
Yes, so am I. John, please, you will ask him to leave.
As soon as he comes in. Ray?
Yeah? Hi. Got some mail for you. Hope you get better news than I did.
I want to talk to you.
Coincidences never cease. There's something I want to ask you, too.
What I've got to say isn't very pleasant. I'd like you to leave as soon as you can. Tonight, if possible.
Have you been talking to our friendly tax man, George Sherston, by chance?
He isn't feeling very friendly toward you.
He shouldn't leave a pretty young wife like that alone. She's bound to get restless.
He says you forced yourself on her.
And you believed him. But of course you did, because that gives you a reason to get rid of me, doesn't it?
Let's call it the last straw.
You're tired of me.
I'm still grateful to you for what you did.
How grateful? John, how much is it worth to you to get rid of me?
Well, if you need a couple of $100.
Couple of hundred? You once offered me $5,000.
I offered you a loan to help you finance an orange grove, if you found one.
Oh, I see. That offer still stand?
On the same conditions.
You're a nice guy, John. You really are. I knew you were a nice guy the first moment I ever saw you. But $5,000 isn't going to get it. I need $20,000. I've got to have it.
$20,000?
I'm in trouble. My past is catching up with me. Just had a letter from an old friend of mine, a retired sea captain. I once saved his life, too. Oh, I told you, saving lives is a hobby of mine. Anyway, he was properly grateful and invested in a small business that I was supposed to start. Now he wants his money back.
And
I haven't got it, but you have. This school of yours is a going concern.
What about the money you saved?
My Air Force pay? Well, I'm saving that for my orange grove. Got to think of my future, you know.
You practically admit you swindled this man out of his money, and now you expect me to lend you some?
You're absolutely right. Lending money always does create a bad feeling. You'd better make it an outright gift.
Why? Why should I?
Well, let's put it this way. Now, if you had known in advance that you could save your child from drowning by paying $20,000, you'd have paid it, wouldn't you? Well, of course you would. So I just extended you credit. I saved the child first and gave you a chance to pay later. I think the price is very reasonable, don't you? It's payday, John.
You are going on a long journey to your local stations, but please do not disembark or you'll miss the last half of our story.
You're gonna love what just popped up. Pop chips from Pop Secret. The chips that start with popcorn. Light, crispy taste. 60% less fat than potato chips. Pop chips. Chips you'll love to pop.
Hey, you.
Huh?
Suit up, strap in, and ask yourself, do you have it?
Have what?
Nickelodeon Guts, now for your Super Nintendo Entertainment System. This is serious, realistic sports action just like the show, only now you're in total control. Compete against the clock or challenge a friend as you take on seven of Guts' toughest events, including the awesome Aggro Crag. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Best out of three? Nickelodeon Guts, only on the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. Also from Nickelodeon, Rocko's Modern Life, the game.
Now, big cleaning performance, lightweight and cordless. Boss Light cleans bare floors, then turn on the brush roll for carpets. So affordable, you'll want two. Cordless Boss Light from Eureka, the next generation.
Hello out there from TV Land, it's really great to see you. Get great TV pleasure from Nick at Night.
I don't mind the local stations identifying themselves, but they seem bent on identifying a large number of other people as well. But take heart, we have only one more interruption before we return to our play.
Hitchcock's not done with you yet. Honest. So stay with Nick at Night.
Sinus sufferers, how come your pill doesn't relieve sinus pressure 24 hours? Efodac 24 does. Other pills last 6 hours or 12, but one Efodac relieves 24 hours. Efodac. Keep sinus pressure from coming back.
Disselfink.
Ah, yeah, well, it's a little known fact that a Disselfink is a filter that purifies Amazon river water.
A Disselfink is a stylized bird found in Pennsylvania Dutch art.
Ah, well, yeah, it also took on that meaning after the Eisenhower administration.
It's Balderdash, the game where you don't have to know the definition to wacky real words. Just bluff them.
Wayne Dillo.
Sure, well, that's an armadillo who's been run over by a truck full of guitars. Play Balderdash. It's a definition of a good time.
We now return to Alfred Hitchcock Presents on Nick at Night.
Did you find out what you suspected?
We're right. Where's Tony?
I put him to bed as soon as he came home. Ray hasn't seen him all day.
Good. Oh, hello, John.
Did you bring the money?
There isn't going to be any money.
Suit yourself. I can sit it out here all summer if I have to.
You're leaving tonight, Ray.
Oh, no, John, no, John, no, John, no.
I drove down to Carmel this afternoon and saw an old friend, General Beckett. He made some inquiries for me. There never was any Ray Roscoe in the Air Force.
You mean I don't exist? Well, then I guess I'll have to throw your kid back in the ocean.
Get out.
You're not reading me very good, John. I like it here. Nice climate. Lots of pretty women. Kira. Eve. Your wife's not bad either.
Oh, John,
please, John, don't be physical. You're not the type.
If you don't leave right now, I'm going to call the police.
And what are you going to tell the police, John? That I saved your child from drowning? That you were properly grateful and invited me to stay in your home? And then you threw me out? Oh, come on. You know, Sally, Kira thinks you're jealous of her. I could give a nice little story to the newspapers. A scandal at South Mead School. Headmaster's wife and foreign girl in triangle with hero who saved child's life. Mitchell boy says, I still believe in Uncle Ray. Tony would do that for me, too. That kid's crazy about me.
Well, he won't be so crazy about you when he finds out you lied to him about being in the Air Force.
The papers will never believe that story.
They might not believe it, but they'll print it. And a lot of high-principled parents will be reading it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll take a little walk outside. I know you two have a lot to discuss. Oh, John, that's, 20,000. That's a 2 and 4 zeros.
I just can't believe it. It's monstrous. Two ordinary people haven't done anything to be ashamed of. We must be able to get rid of a man like that.
We can. We'll go to the police.
To kill me.
Ray. Ray.
He's all right. He's just knocked out.
I'll get some water.
No. Leave him. He'll come around soon enough. Be a lot less trouble if he didn't.
What happened? How did it start?
Came to the trailer again today. I wasn't there. He tried to attack Eve.
Oh, no.
She fought him off, scratched his face, and when she told me, I grabbed a gun and came over.
I'll call the police.
No! I came after him with a gun. I fired at him. That's assault with a deadly weapon.
George, you said he was strangling you. I'll back up your story.
No, you don't understand. This'll be in the papers. The Civil Service Commission will read it. Even if I don't go to jail, I'll lose my job for sure.
They won't stand for anything messing your personal life.
But you were trying to protect your wife. It'll be Ray's story against the three of us. They don't fire a man for protecting his home and family.
Look, that sounds very noble. But it won't read like that. I know what's happened to other men in the department who've gotten mixed up in less than this. The slightest cloud of suspicion and I'll be finished.
You're still unconscious.
Better call a doctor.
I'll take him to the hospital. Where's the nearest?
Centerville.
Can you help me with him to the car?
I can't sleep.
Neither can I.
Poor George. I hope he managed all right at the hospital.
He was so scared.
Not his job.
I know.
Hello? Yes, George. No. Are you sure? All right, I'll be right over. Just before George got Ray to the hospital, he noticed that he'd stopped breathing.
What?
Ray's dead. I killed him.
Leo, what are you doing?
You told me to lower the price on large boxes of Bold.
Now get the cleaning and softening of Bold at a new low price.
How far do you have to go for great tasting water? As far as your faucet. The Brita water filtration pitcher has the special Brita filter that reduces chlorine, lead, the things nature never intended. And the taste? Wonderful. Brita. Tap into great taste. Available at Target.
This is the recreation for the TV generation, making every minute count. It's Nick. At
night. I'm so glad you came. He won't listen to me.
Where is he?
Over there.
George! You can't do
this. I know what I'm doing.
We've got to go to the police. We have to tell them the truth.
They'll never believe us. Never. Listen to me. I've had more chance to think about this than you. This is the only thing to do.
But it was an accident.
Can you convince the police of that? You know the questions they'll ask? Why did you kill Ray Roscoe, Mr. Mitchell?
He was strangling you.
Self-defense when it was two against one and he was unarmed?
I didn't mean to kill him.
Did you call a doctor? You saw he was badly injured.
We tried to get him to the hospital.
Can you prove that?
My wife.
Did you like Ray Roscoe, Mr. Mitchell?
No.
Then why did you keep him in your house? Was he blackmailing you? You wanted to get rid of him, didn't you? You wanted him dead. And you killed him.
That's enough.
Look, that's only a sample. Think of the questions they're going to ask me about Eve. Why I brought a gun to your place. Can't you see it's the only thing to do? Or we'll both be facing a murder charge.
But the last query is, what happened to him?
No one will know. Eve and I'll be away from here in an hour. We'll keep in touch with you in case there should be any trouble. John, I'm sorry about this.
It isn't your fault.
Brought it on himself. Even though he is dead, I still hate his guts.
I'll help.
No. You better go home. And you tell Sally what we've decided. I'll finish here.
All right.
Can we go to the beach this morning, Mom?
Well, if I don't have time, Kira can take you.
I wish Uncle Ray was still here. He's much better at volleyball than Kira.
I told you, Tony. He had to go away. You know we only invited him for a few days anyway.
Your mail, Mr. Mitchell.
Thank you, Kira. Tony, run along and finish your breakfast with Kira, would you please?
Why? I always have it in here.
Do as I say.
I'll do you some eggs, the special way you like them.
There's a letter for Ray.
Get rid of it. Tear it up. He's out of our lives. He never existed.
Sally, he isn't out of our lives. Whoever sent this letter knows he was staying here. It was sent care of us. Dear Mr. Roscoe, I've had no word from you about the $20,000 you owe me. It seems I'm unable to force you to return this, but let me tell you, I shall spare no expense to expose you and have you arrested for fraud. Unless the money is in my hands within 24 hours, I'm putting the whole matter in the hands of the police. Captain Charles Faulkner, Seagate Apartments, Santa Monica. I'm looking for a man named Faulkner. His landlord said I might be able to find him here.
That's him.
Thanks. Mr. Faulkner.
Captain Faulkner.
Yeah. My name is Mitchell. I'm from the South Mead School in Dana.
Oh, yeah. Friend of Roscoe's.
Well, he was just staying with us for a while.
Was staying with you? Where is he now?
Well, he left our place very suddenly. He didn't tell me where he was going.
I don't believe you.
Your letter just came this morning, right after Ray left.
Oh, you're in the habit of opening other people's mail, are you?
There was no forwarding address on the outside. I thought it might be important.
You bet it's important. I'm setting the dogs on that lad, mister. Took me 3 months to run him down at your place, and I'll find him again.
Maybe I could help.
I'll go to the police this time. They'll splatter the name of Ray Roscoe all over the country.
Couldn't we keep it down a little?
Why, let the whole world know. Roscoe swindled me out of nearly every penny I had.
But he might have some friends. They could warn him.
Crooks like that don't have any friends.
Look, how much did he take you for?
$20,000.
That's an awful lot of money.
You're telling me it's a lot. My whole nest egg, practically. He was going to buy a fishing boat company with it. I was the first fish he caught. Well, I'm wiggling off the hook, matey, and getting my money back.
I'd like to give you that money myself.
Why? It ain't your debt.
Roscoe did something for me. He saved my boy from drowning. I guess there's some good in everyone.
Well, there's no good in this lad, matey. Don't let him get off the hook.
I'd like to settle our account. I don't like being under obligation to a man like that.
I don't like it.
$20,000.
That should make us both even with him.
That don't make sense.
The check's good, I assure you. You can call the bank.
Yeah, but this is Saturday. I can't go to the bank till Monday morning. That gives Roscoe two more days to get lost if you're in cahoots.
I can't lay my hands on $20,000 cash right this minute.
Well, you got something in mind. I take the check and you run to the cops. Accuse me of bilking you or something.
Look.
No, I think I better go to the cops myself. Get them to flush out Ray Roscoe.
Be reasonable. I'm a reputable owner of a boys' school. Why should I be mixed up with a man like Roscoe? I dislike him as much as you do, maybe even more.
Yeah, well, that's why it don't make sense for you to be laying out $20,000 for him.
Captain Falker, will you listen?
Easy, guys. Why don't you take it out in the alley?
I'm sorry. I'm a little on edge. Problems at the school. Now this... I'm sorry.
Let's go. I guess I know how you feel. I'll take the check.
Everything's gonna be all right.
Will be as soon as I get to the bank Monday morning.
Don't worry about that. Goodbye, Captain.
Sure, Gold MasterCard has at least a $5,000 credit line, so you can buy all kinds of things, but you can't buy time. Well, I don't know. You could buy plane tickets and fly across five time zones, and it'll be even earlier than when you left. You can even go to Switzerland, and that's a great place to buy time. But wherever you go, you won't have to waste your time looking for a great exchange rate, because with MasterCard, a great exchange rate is exactly what you'll get. So I guess Gold MasterCard really can buy you time. Just remember to set your watch back. Watch back. Now how's that for a useful card? Gold MasterCard, it's more than a gold card, it's smart money.
Our lives are ultra intense. We have major pressures. So Secret made something revolutionary for us. Ultra Dry. This is huge. Keeps you drier than any other kind out there. A new pH-balanced soft solid that goes on dry and vanishes like that. So two clicks give us ultimate dryness. Our lives demand it. New Secret Ultra Dry. Strong enough for him. But now, the ultimate in dryness for us.
What do you need when you're on the way home and not quite light speed and you're late for the dinner you're supposed to be making and serving and eating and you're just not moving? Hello to you too, and you're the slightest bit edgy and nervous and tense and you need something soothing, and that's just not soothing, and this needs to boil. Just something that's good with a taste that's more zingy that might make you feel better, and you want it right now? V8!
With a full serving of vegetables.
Ah.
It might just make you feel better.
The National Weather Service gives hurricanes stupid names. What does Nick at Night want?
Hurricane named Superman, if you ask me.
Nick at Night demands a hurricane named Superman.
When your day has been an emotional thrill, and you feel like you're turning into Godzilla,
get the big TV pleasure of Nick at Night.
Not there.
What is it, John?
They're making a survey for a new freeway right through that old quarry.
You mean where George Hurston buried...
They'll find it. When they start digging, they'll find it.
Wouldn't it be almost a relief if they did?
Relief? The police will move in.
Is that any worse than what we've been going through for 3 weeks?
I've got to find Hurston. Get him to move that body.
John, wait a minute, please. Let's be reasonable. We keep getting in deeper and deeper. You thought it'd be all over when you paid off Mr. Faulkner. Now there's this. There'll always be something to keep us on edge. And if it doesn't happen, we'll be expecting it to happen.
Ocean View Park. That's where the Sherstons are now. I'll drive up there right away.
No, John. John, go to the police yourself.
We've gone too far for that. What could I tell them
now? The truth.
And what if George panics and puts all the blame on me? Remember, I was the one who killed Roscoe.
In self-defense, John. Oh, darling, you're an intelligent man. How many times have you said the full truth can never hurt? You tell that to your students.
It's different when it happens to hit home. I'm going to Sherston.
John.
John!
Nothing's gone wrong, has it?
They've decided to put a road through your old campsite. They're making a survey and digging up the whole area, right where Roscoe's body's buried.
Oh, no.
Wait. Nothing to worry about yet. If they're just making a survey now, it'll take weeks before they start digging.
We have to remove that body right away, tonight.
John, it's Saturday. People are all over that place weekend. I tell you what, we'll go back Monday night.
No, it can't wait. I wouldn't have a moment's peace.
Take it easy, John. George is right. Monday would be safer.
I'm sorry, Eve. You don't have to come with me. I can fight it myself.
John, wait. I didn't realize that you were this upset. I'll tell you what you do. You go on home and forget all about it. I'll take care of Roscoe.
No, we're in this together.
I've got the trailer. I'm going to have to take him and bury him somewhere else. That's a risk. Why should you take it too?
I let you go through this alone once before. This time I share the responsibility.
I said I'd do it.
What I meant was that there's no need for you to stick your neck out.
I want to.
All right. We better meet there, then. Let's say 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock.
And blends and chops to give you the kitchen in your hand. The new Braun Multimix.
It's party time, people. So pick up those party platters. Pick up some pickles. Some classic pickles. Pick up your poultry, your pot roast. Save the pickle platter. But be sure and pick the perfect pickle. Pick a Vlasic. The perfect pickle for picking it up.
Why is Rob Petrie smiling when he's supposed to be upset? Let's find out with Nick at Night's classic TV Rewind. In this scene from the Dick Van Dyke Show, Rob recognizes a song he composed playing on the radio, so he calls up the radio station. But how does he know the correct number? Shouldn't he have looked up the number before he dialed it?
Right.
So that's why he's smiling. Classic TV Rewinds, a second look at shows that are always worth a second look on Nick at Night.
John, I've been so worried. What did they say?
Sherston practically broke down. He begged me not to go to the police.
Don't let him influence you, dear. He's just worrying about his government job, that's all.
I think it was something else. I had a feeling he wasn't being straight with me. He was so insistent on going there alone. There's something he's hiding from us.
John, please listen to me. Go to the police right now. I'll go with you.
No, not yet. I'm going to meet Sherston at the quarry in just an hour. I want to be sure.
Well, let me go with you. We'll both...
No, stay there.
John, please.
Thank you.
hasn't arrived yet.
Hello, Sally. I thought I'd get started. No sense just standing around.
What time are you supposed to meet John?
9 o'clock.
Yeah, we made better time on the highway than we expected.
Have you already...
Yes.
It's still only 8:45. If I hadn't come, you would have finished and left before John had a chance to arrive.
Why not? It wasn't a very pleasant job. You ought to be glad.
You wanted to do it alone. John said you wanted to do it alone.
I only wanted to do him a favor.
Favor? Like the night you buried Ray? You didn't wait for John that night either. Why not? What were you afraid of? You didn't want John to see the body because you killed Ray, didn't you?
I've had enough of this. We're clearing out of here right now.
No, you're going to wait for John.
Eve, go start the car. You, get out of here.
Well, if I do, I'm going to go straight to the police. It's true, isn't it? You shot him.
What's the matter, Sally? See a ghost?
Ah, then you see you made all this fuss about nothing. I wasn't even dead.
You were all in this together. This was just a horrible trick to blackmail us.
Well, I rather like to think of it as a good melodrama. Macabre. Grizzly, but very effective.
Hey, let's get going.
Patience, George, patience. After all, Mrs. Mitchell is one of the stars of our little drama. We wouldn't want to cheat her of the clever denouement.
I can't believe you planned the whole thing. How did you manage to be right there when my boy was drowning?
The one flaw in my otherwise perfect script. I simply called out to the boy and lured him into the deeper water.
But suppose he hadn't gone?
Then I had three alternative openings for our little playlet. Fortunately, the first one worked smooth as glass.
You didn't even save him. In fact, you might have killed him.
No, you don't understand good dramaturgy. There would never be a killing in one of my scripts. Oh, come, Captain. No need to whisper. If you have something to say, speak up.
Well, if you ain't gonna wait for Mitchell, let's get rolling.
Oh, Captain Faulkner, this is Mrs. Mitchell. The captain is a senior member of our little repertory company. Confidentially, he's a bit of a ham.
Captain Faulkner.
About your husband. His sense of timing is atrocious. Now, if only he'd given the check to the captain, say, on Friday... We wouldn't have had to hang around here this weekend and play out the final scene for you and John. The final scene should go so long and no longer.
This one's already gone long enough.
You'll never be able to cash that check when John finds out about this.
Why? Why should John stop the check? He has no reason to associate the captain with us. And how could he possibly tie in the check with your disappearance? And if he has an ounce of the actor in him, he'd be so grief-stricken he won't even think of the money. Captain, Eve, you better start driving now. Take the cliff road. And now, Sally, we come to the final scene of our little playlet. I'm truly sorry it had to end this way. But then, except for the final curtain, it's exactly the way I wrote it.
John! Asshole! John!
Kevin's right.
right?
Yes, I'm all right. Oh, you did call the police, you did.
I decided to take your advice for once. I wish you'd taken mine and stayed away from here.
You see, I couldn't really let you kill me. I told you, saving lives was my hobby. Oh, you wouldn't be interested in buying a slightly used trailer, would you?
I think the lesson of our story is quite clear. If a stranger offers to save your life, think it over. You may be letting yourself in for a great deal of trouble. This concludes my part of the program. Next time, I shall return with another story, some scenes of which will be shown after this next and last commercial.
I got the sweet news for the holidays. Hillshire Farm brown sugar hams. Slow smoked and slow cured with my best brown sugar and fully cooked. Happy holidays! Hillshire Farm, taste the difference.
Here's a few tips on making a more effective business presentation from JCPenney.
Open with a dramatic statement by Worthington and make sure your materials are carefully coordinated.
Continue to hold everyone's attention with Stafford. Look smart and well-polished.
Then throw in a few surprising statistics.
Close with Stafford and Worthington.
And you'll walk away knowing you've made an impressive presentation.
JCPenney, doing it right.
For TV of the classic kind, the Nick at Night has been designed for you.
Ooh-wee.